a ring, but not just any ring. The engagement ring. The kind that when he saw it, he'd just know. So Michael looked around online, asked friends for advice.
I want a ring that's special. One that's, you know.
You gotta go to Helzberg.
Michael went to Helzberg Diamonds, where he found an incredible selection of beautiful rings, settings, and both lab-grown and natural diamonds, certified and guaranteed to be of the highest quality. He also met Sarah, a Helzberg Diamond expert, who helped him find that special ring he was looking for, so that when his fiancée opened the box...
Wow, it's...
Yep, sounds right to me. Be like Michael. Find the engagement ring of her dreams at a Helzberg store near you or online at Helzberg.com. And right now at Helzberg Diamonds, take advantage of special financing offers.
Okay, I've got to put in a plug for Kohl's lowest prices of the season. I got myself a pair of cozy sweats for under $18, found my sister the cutest boots for Christmas, just $29.99. And with the 50% off kitchen and dining essentials, I'm all set to host for the holidays. Not to mention, I got 80% off clearance finds and earned Kohl's cash. So yeah, get to Kohl's and thank me later. Select styles ends October 23rd. Some exclusions apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
Hi, I'm Capri, and the little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Grill Spicy Deluxe is the chicken. They actually put it on the grill, cooked it in the sauce. It's definitely a good grilled spicy sandwich.
Hey, I'm Michelle, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Grilled Spicy Deluxe is it's spicy and it's full of flavor. When you pair that with the Kale Crunch Salad, it's just good.
Order a Grilled Spicy Deluxe sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Available for a limited time. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
Hey, to become the next generation of innovators, entrepreneurs, and creators, we're going to need something.
Like a high-speed internet connection that can turn my ideas into reality.
Like the skills to become the world's most powerful coder.
Like the tools to start my sustainable shoe business.
You just heard some of the millions of students Comcast is supporting through Project Up, our comprehensive initiative and $1 billion commitment to open doors for the next generation so they can build a future of unlimited possibilities. Learn more at Comcast.com/Project Up.
Hey, it's Cuz. Are you getting ready for a home improvement cleanup? The garage, the bathroom, big move? Let me tell you about the perfect solution, the Baxter. The Baxter is by far the most convenient, affordable way to help with your cleanup. The Baxter isn't just a great product. It's a 3-cubic yard dumpster in a bag sold at Home Depot, Lowe's, local home improvement stores everywhere, and for only $29.99. Holds 3,300 pounds of waste. Buy it, fill it, schedule your collection, poof, it's gone. Clean it up with the Baxter dumpster. In the back.
Don't miss Guntoberfest this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at the Greater Philadelphia Expo Center in Oaks.
Guntoberfest is the East Coast's largest gun show with over 2,000 tables.
This weekend only, buy, sell, or trade from guns, rifles, pistols, and ammo to military surplus, uniforms, medals, and more. Don't miss Guntoberfest at the Greater Philadelphia Expo Center in Oaks this Friday, 1 to 7, Saturday, 9 to 5, and Sunday, 9 to 4. For info, visit eagleshows.com.
That's eagleshows.com.
Hey guys, Andrew. Start NFL Week 7 off with a no-sweat same-game parlay from FanDuel in partnership with Valley Forge. Whether you're new to FanDuel or not, you get free bets back if your Thursday night same-game parlay doesn't hit. Same-game parlays combine bets for a chance at a bigger payout. This one could actually be pretty fun because the last couple have been ugly. Kyler Murray and the Cards versus Alvin Kamara and the Saints. You can go with Murray over in passing yards, Murray and over rushing yards, Kamara in anytime touchdown score, James Conner in anytime touchdown score. All kinds of options for you to choose from. Build yours or choose from one of the popular pre-built SGPs. However you want to play, bet the NFL on Thursday night with a no-sweat same-game parlay. Bet the NFL on Thursday night. No-sweat same-game parlay. Just sign up with promo code Fanatic. So whether you're new to FanDuel or a current user, you're all set. Just download the app with promo code Fanatic and make every moment more with FanDuel, an official sports betting partner of the NFL.
21 plus and present PA. 3 plus lakes. Minimum $1 required. Refund issued as non-withdrawable. Free bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Max free bet $5. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
WPEN Burlington, Philadelphia, a Beasley Media Group station, home of the most entertaining sports talk in Philadelphia. 97.5 The Fanatic, Philadelphia. Win $1,000 right now. 97.5 The Fanatic is bleeding green.
Yes, we are. We are bleeding green and red, as you know. And right now, here's your word to win $1,000. Text the word HOME to 45911, or you can enter it on the Fanatic app or at 975thefanatic.com. That's the word home, H-O-M-E. One winner selected at random will win $1,000 in this company-wide contest. Winners will get a call from Beasley, so be sure to answer your phone. Complete rules at 975thefanatic.com. 975thefanatic's Bleeding Green is presented by the Bet Park Sportsbook Casino. Have everything you want in a digital casino and sportsbook. Please never text and drive. Good luck.
It's time now for Cuz Radio.
What up, Cuz?
Deshaun Jackson gets a block. Are you kidding?
Talking with the Cuz.
Yo, Cuz. How you doing?
Stairs rips one into the night.
Stolen by the doctor. Yes, he's got it. Here he comes. Ray rocked the baby to sleep and slammed up.
Look, Cuz, don't even try it, okay?
Now here's Anthony Gargano.
Why don't you get the hell out of here, Cuz?
Well, good morning, everybody. Happy Thursday to all across the Delaware Valley. A bit of a bummer. I realize that. I mean, I was like everybody else with you guys thinking we're going to be up 2-0 in this series. Larry Boadamas saw the two wins. We were very hopeful, right? Nola coming in, and you thought, well, listen, you know, just get to Snell, get him wild. And he was wild, right? Like, the tough thing about it was he was wild. And they get four runs off of him early. And that's the shame of it. And they're up 4-0. And it was weird because those back-to-back home runs on consecutive pitches, Drury lines one. It was just like a low seed that he lines one. It really kind of was half cheap. It was hard. It was on a rope, but it was kind of cheap. And then, of course, Bell hits the second pitch and bombs it. And it's 4-2, and you're going, you like more. And I thought that Snell would continue to kind of unravel. He got it together. And the issue comes in the fifth, and we go back. I thought that he was done with – that Nola was done with the fifth-inning issues, the fifth-inning troubles. That's the one thing I'm disappointed at, is you kept thinking that, all right, well, he's done with that sort of thing. So, you know, having a lead, having Nola on the mound, you felt good, especially as the shadows come in. And, of course, they make mention of it. It was a hot day. We thought the ball would travel yesterday in San Diego. It was hot. There was a high sun. You saw early that the outfielders had a lot of issues with the fly balls. Then what happens is when the sun shifts over the mountain, you create some shadows, right? And that usually is advantage pitcher all the way. But Nola just couldn't make it work, and it just kind of got ugly in that fifth inning. And, man, oh, man, it's almost reminds me of that Cliff Lee game when you got a lead and you could kill him. Like, that was the nail. That was the stake in the heart of the Padres. And, you know, I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'm worried. You know, I love the fact that they're coming home even. And if you tell me before the series starts that they're going to come back to a wild Citizens Bank Park on Friday, I'm happy. I'd take that all day long. A split in San Diego, coming home with three at CBP, I feel great about that. The only issue is the way you lose game two, right? Having a lead. Nola, who was not Nola-like. Again, he finishes his 4 2/3, 7 hits, 6 earned runs. That's not Nola-like, right? So we come home, it's 1-1. And the other issue is, and, you know, this scares me, is that you got Suarez, who's been kind of hit or miss, and then a bullpen game before you go back to Wheeler on Sunday. Now, I kind of look at it like this. Need to see if you guys agree. I just got to steal one of the two, right? If I steal Friday or Saturday, now we're even, and now I got Wheeler, right? And then I feel confident about Wheeler on Sunday. Now I'm up 3-2, and all we got to do is win one more, and we'll have Nola coming back. So, you know, I'll take my chances up 3-2 going back to San Diego saying, go ahead, you know what, I could win one of those two. What I can't have is being down 3-2. That's what scares me. So, you know, you're going to have to either win with Suarez. Now, it's a little tough because they got Musgrove going, who's pretty good. And on Saturday, their bullpen game is essentially a battle of bullpens. But they got Clevinger, who was a starter. He was in Cleveland. He's pretty much stretched out. So they kind of have the advantage in the first two pitching games, right, over Friday and Saturday. So the bats, it's going to be incumbent on the bats to be alive. We need the brutes at home, and we need the crowd to be wild. That's what it's going to be. We definitely need to, like, we need the crowd to get nuts and to be wild and throaty and scary. That's the mission for the weekend. I don't want us to get down. I know today we're going to react. And, you know, full disclosure, I'm kind of bummed. I was hoping, I got greedy. And the way the game starts, being up 4-0, I'm kind of greedy and I kind of feel bummed today. So we got to get it out of our system today. And then tomorrow, get back to like celebrating this thing and get back to being loud and wild and the zoo that everybody expects it to be. Good morning, Chunez.
What's up, man? How are we today?
You know, I mean, like, I think I kind of, I think you and I feel the same way.
Yeah, listen, so I'm disappointed they lost, right? I mean, that sucks, and Aaron Nola has the lead. You just pointed it out perfectly with the Cliff Lee situation. But I'm not going to say right now, look, I saw a lot of, and I don't want to call it overreaction, but I saw a lot of reaction on social media after the game of, oh my God, all the momentum's on the Padres' side now. This could be the moment you lost the series, blah, blah, blah. And I go, oh, hold on a second. It's 1-1. It's not like they took the 2-1 series lead, or it's not like you were down 2-1 and you had a chance of tying the series and now they go up 3-1. It's 1-1 and you're coming back to Philadelphia. You still have the home field advantage. We saw this play out exactly the same way against Atlanta. Now, you didn't have a lead that you blew, but you had opportunities to score runs in that game two against Atlanta. And unfortunately, it took a misplayed ground ball by Rhys Hoskins, and before that, a 15-minute delay from Ronald Acuna that really changed the momentum of that game. That game yesterday was momentum Padres, but I can't go series momentum Padres because of that one game, because look at what just happened last week. The Phillies came right back and punched the Braves right back in the mouth. Now, if the Phillies lose tomorrow, now it's a cause of concern because now you're down 2-1. You're going to have to go back to San Diego. And if it plays out some sort of way where it looks like they carried that momentum over from game two, all right, I'll be worried. But I'm not sitting here freaking out today. And I did see a lot of people say, wow, this is, you know, the series is completely turned over into the Padres' favor after that game. And I can't go that far just yet.
Yeah, I guess I kind of in between, right? Like, I agree with you. Like, I saw this team, you know, it was the same situation, you know, with the Braves, right? You come back, you lose, you win game one, you lose game two.
Yep.
Now, the only difference is you lost with Suarez, you came home to Nola.
Right.
Which is different. And the only thing that makes me a little bit more scared, and again, I'm not giving you, like, all of a sudden the Padres have momentum, but they did wake up, their bats woke up a little bit, and the only thing that scares me is they have the advantage in game three, which is Musgrove over
yes.
Suarez.
Yeah, I agree, but I'll say this. I think Suarez settles down. Like, what happened his last outing, I think I chalk it up to postseason nerves, and he was on the road. He was in Atlanta. As corny as the chop thing is, uh-huh. I can see where that gets to a pitcher when the bases are loaded in the first inning, right? And that's what was going on. It was dicey, really, from first pitch against the Braves. So I'm hoping at his home crowd, and he got that first playoff appearance out of the way, and we've always talked about this, right, for years now.
how playoff experience matters for these young guys, and that's why we just wanted to get in 2 years ago. That's why we just wanted to get in last year, because playoff experience matters. Because when you're ready to win, or when you're supposedly ready to win, you don't want to have those playoff nerves get in the way of that. The Phillies, they weren't they're not supposed to be ready to win this year. But look at where they're at. They're in the NLCS. Yeah,
I'm greedy, man. I'm
right, exactly.
The World
they're
Series.
In the NLCS, so that goes out the window.
They play the Astros. They play the Astros.
Right.
I know how great they are. So be it. But like, this run has been so much fun.
Oh, it's been incredible.
And we have fallen in love with these guys. And I don't want to say goodbye to them.
No, neither do I. But and that's why I'm saying that's out the window. That, like, they weren't supposed to be here. That's out the window. And the beauty is Suarez got an outing under his belt already. He understands the nerves of a playoff game. Look, they said it during the broadcast yesterday. Do I think Connor Brogdon's any good? No. But Connor Brogdon, they told the story, admitted to Rob Thompson that his first outing in the playoffs, he was nervous. He was nervous, right? Like, we're all human. He was nervous. So Rob Thompson did the right thing and had him go back out there when they were up 9-1. He ended the game. And look, he looked okay yesterday. Maybe Suarez was dealing with that same thing where he, as a human being, was nervous pitching in the biggest moment of his career. And maybe he comes back down to earth a little bit in a good way tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm okay right now. I'm not, like, there's a lot of panic. Yeah. Like, let's, deep breath.
Yeah, I'm not panic. I I'm in between this. Like, I don't know if I'm, you're like, you're whistling. I'm
okay.
Yeah, I need a day not to, I'm not whistling today.
Okay.
Tomorrow, like, I need a rhythm. I'm a rhythm guy, right? So, how I deal with stuff, I look at today. Now, intellectually, it's different because I just wanted to get a split. So I achieved my goal, right?
And we said this series might go 6 or 7. From the jump, we said this.
No, I know we did. And, I got greedy. I got to come clean to you. I got greedy.
Greed is good.
They're up 4-0. I got Nola on the hill. I'm going, I'm winning this series in 5. That's where my head was. And I'll be honest with you, I'm shocked they didn't win the game.
Greed
is good.
Oh, didn't play through. Damn it.
Yeah.
Greed is good.
There you go. Well, man, it's good. That's all right. You can be greedy. I'm not crushing you for being greedy.
It's what built this great country known as the United States of America.
Greed works.
Come on, man. Listen, it's okay to be greedy.
That's right, Gecko.
But we can't all of a sudden panic because they lost that game.
But I'm not panicking. You don't hear panic in my voice. But I'm strained. Like, I'm not whistling. You're whistling. I can't go whistle. You know what I mean? Like, I still feel good, but you have to admit, that's a gut punch, and it does change the series a little bit.
Oh, well, it does change the series. Yeah, you're up 2-0 coming home. They're not going back to San Diego.
Looking at the pitching matchups.
Yes.
Like, the matchups, Musgrove's no joke.
No, he's no joke. He's not.
I need the bats. Like, here's my trust. I'm going to throw out Suarez. Like, I hear what you're saying about Suarez. I don't have as much confidence in him that you do. But here's what I believe in. I believe in the magic of the Phillies bats. I believe in the magic of Bryce Harper. And I'm going to go into tomorrow's game saying they're going to get to Musgrove. I'm going to go into Saturday's game saying they're going to get to Clevinger and whoever else they throw at them. And I'm going to believe in the Phillies bats. I'm going to believe in the brutes, right? I'm going to believe in Harper, and I'm going to believe in Reese, who, guess what? I love his display of emotion now.
Yeah, I do too, Mr. Football Guy. But I also have to see his display of emotion now. He needs to stop looking at pitches right down the heart of the plate at bat. Not even the ones that he strikes out on. He's looking at pitches down the pipe.
Well, they got
every
caught,
at
a couple
bat.
Of them got caught like that yesterday. You saw that.
Yeah, and it happened against Darvish too. JT, Darvish was mixing around the pitches very well. But I mean, dude, it's every at bat with Reese. He's looking at 2-1 fastballs. He's looking at 0-2 pitches right down the plate.
But you know why they're doing that, right? Like against Snell, they were looking at Snell trying to get Snell wild. I mean, that's the whole thing with Snell, is if he can't locate. And early on, now, it was a bunch of, I will say, it was a bunch of bleeders and.
Yeah.
It was good fortune. There were a lot of blessings, you know, blessing base runners off of that, yes, off of Snell. But I thought he would, I'm shocked. I thought he would unravel, dude, and he battled back.
Yeah, and there was one moment, it wasn't the four-run inning, it was the next inning where they I think they got a base runner on. You could see he was talking to himself on the mound. And I'm like, oh, that's never good. Like, if you're talking to yourself, like,
right.
maybe this works out in the Phillies' favor. Like, I've seen Scherzer do it, but Scherzer's just a freak where, like, he's really good. Snell's not like that.
No,
but look, he's settled down. You got to give him credit. And then the Padres' bats got hot. You know, Aaron's brother killed him yesterday. That sucks.
I know. Now, I don't know. Like, I look at that lineup. I'm not afraid of that lineup.
No, you
dude.
Got your big boppers and Soto and Machado, right. who That's did it. Damage yesterday. Josh Bell can, you know, hit a tank, as right. we saw yesterday.
Right. That freaking Drury.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you.
That barely got out.
It was a seed, though. I'll be honest with you. I don't know why they play Myers over him.
Yeah, at this point.
Drury can hit.
He's just been struggling all playoffs except for yesterday.
Well, I mean, Myers stinks. Like, I don't know why they don't even, whatever. That's their problem. But, like, Grisham will never get a hit.
No.
Right?
No, he looks terrible.
I mean, he's horrible. He's overmatched. Profar stinks. Right? I mean, stop. Kim, he stinks. He's not Tatis.
No.
So, Cronenworth's all right. Like, you know, he's got a little lefty, you know, pop. But that lineup, that's what, like, if I can get, because I do think, I want to talk myself into winning the next three.
Oh yeah, I'll be at the clincher on Sunday. I'm already planning for it.
Dude, I want this bad, man. I want this bad.
I already told the sitter, because, you know, Christy's going to come to the game with me. I already told the sitter, by the way, it's going to take a long time to get home because people are going to be celebrating. I'm, you know, I already know what's happening. Phillies in five. Suarez gives you a good outing tomorrow. You do the
bats,
bullpen,
I need bats.
Bullpen
the
game,
bats.
Game four. And then, you know, Wheeler shuts down the door.
Yeah, well, I got a little faith in the world, Wheeler. But you give me the bats tomorrow? Like, I need the brutes.
Yeah, I could see a couple bops. I mean, look,
right.
Schwarber and Harper. A couple bops, man. I mean, Harper still played a good game yesterday. He's hot, dude. He's just red hot right now.
Oh, my God, is he hot. How about the at-bats he gives you, dude? He says these at-bats
are incredible. You just need Hoskins and Cassianos to do their part.
JT hit a couple hard outs yesterday,
yes,
too.
Yes, he did. They'll fall.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I feel.
Hey, you'll have your lefty lineup, so you'll have your Marsh and your Stott, and we'll see what happens.
I need Stott back in the lineup.
Here, I'm going to play this. All right.
I like it.
I know. It was everybody's freaking out yesterday.
Nobody's freaking out.
No, there were people freaking out. Yeah, I saw Tyrone all upset on social media. Ricky Bo all upset on social media. And then, of course, I saw the fans.
Ricky Bo gets upset if he spills a drop of coffee, right?
I need everybody to take a deep breath. Johnny the K said there's a historical collapse yesterday because it's the 4-0 lead. Because that doesn't happen in playoff baseball. Look, I get it. Just take a deep breath, everyone, for crying out loud.
I know, dude. I'm not freaking out. I'm just trying to, you know. I got to talk my way through it today.
I hear you.
Can you help me talk my way through it
today? I would love to.
Tomorrow, when we're back at Chickie's in Malvern and the bet part, the Park Sportsbook inside Chickie's in Malvern, I'm going to get nuts, right? Like, we'll have all of our guests back and get you fired up, blah, 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 blah. You know, but right now, you know, I need a.
Yo, man, we love you.
Stay right with you, son.
All right, 610-632-0975 is how you join us. 610-632-0975, Cuz Radio with the Judas. Deep breath. All right, we got a lot to talk about, too, man. Even though it's a bye week, we'll dive all into this series, as you know. But we got to talk Sixers tonight, too. Sixers Bucks tonight. And I got to get that loss the other night out of my system. All right? Hey, let me tell you about my man, Anthony.
Anthony!
Yeah, Anthony LaBruciato. Listen, Andy was telling me about this incredible new software he uses where you can see in 3D how your new roof, siding, windows are going to look before you decide on the color or the style. I mean, it's unbelievable. But now you know like how I love Anthony, right? And I'm happy to recommend Anthony, experts at LaBruce Shadow Roofing Exteriors, because hiring the wrong company to replace your roof, windows, or siding could be a disaster. So you call Anthony. He's the contractor of the year in Mid-Atlantic by CertainTeed. Colder weather is he almost here, right? It's a little chilly in the mornings. Don't wait. Now, Andy told me about the damage that is caused by ice damming. It's no good. Now, this is where the water gets stuck in between your house expands. It gets stuck and it freezes, all right? And if your little roof's looking tired or has a small leak or your windows are drafty or your siding's cracked, showing signs of mold, don't worry. Just call Anthony, all right? Anthony Labruciano, the shingle master at Labruciano. They're proud of every single job they do, especially yours. Hundreds of five-star Google reviews. Trust Anthony Labruciano Roofing and Exteriors. Call him 610-265-ROOF or go to paroofpros.com.
Fanatics Sports Update.
Series tied. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this update is brought to you by Chickies and Pizza in Malvern. Grab lunch at Chickies and Pizza in Malvern this Friday with a cuz and myself, the Chunas, as we get you ready for the Birds game. That's Chickies and Pizza in Malvern this and every Friday for lunch with a cuz and myself, the Chunas. The Phillies dropped game two yesterday. It sucked. They were up 4-0, and all of a sudden it was 7-4, and the Phillies ended up losing. But don't panic. The series is tied at 1-1. It comes back to Philadelphia. They're off today. Both teams off today. Back in action tomorrow. Ranger Suarez will get the start for the Phillies, hoping to make a better start than what he did against the Braves in that game one, which the Phillies did win. Joe Musgrove will get the start for the Padres. Sixers back in action today, hoping to flip the script after losing their first game against the Celtics. Tonight, home opener against the Milwaukee Bucks. Tip off at 7:30. You can listen live right here on The Fanatic. This update is also brought to you by the Philadelphia Museum of Art. Matisse in the 1930s. It's not Matisse Thybulle. Now at the Philadelphia Museum of Art, learn how creating a mural from Philadelphia helped Matisse get his mojo back. Open late Fridays. Book tickets at philamuseum.org. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this is 97.5 The Fanatic.
Anthony Gargano, weekdays 10 to 2 on 97.5 The Fanatic.
Ad paid for by the Sentinel Group. Attention, Marines, military personnel, families, and contractors who were stationed at Camp Lejeune. Were you present at Camp Lejeune between August 1953 and December of 1987? You may be entitled to significant compensation. For nearly 34 years, those in the Marine Corps base Camp Lejeune were exposed to contaminated drinking water, resulting in devastating injuries, including several forms of cancer, adverse birth outcomes, Parkinson's disease, and more. North Carolina's procedural laws have prevented victims from getting the justice they deserve, but passage of the Camp Lejeune Justice Act of 2022 would allow you or a loved one to file a lawsuit seeking compensation for illnesses and injuries linked to the toxic water. Call today for your free consultation. 800-484-9358. Let our experienced attorneys fight to get you the compensation you deserve, and you pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call 800-484-9358. That's 800-484-9358. Again, 800-484-9358.
There's a reason Comcast Business powers more businesses than any other provider. Actually, there's a few. Comcast Business offers the fastest reliable network, the peace of mind that comes with Security Edge, helping to protect all your connected devices, and the most reliable 5G mobile network. Want me to keep going? I can. Whether your small business is starting or growing, you need Comcast Business. Technology solutions that put you ahead and give you serious savings. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Get started with fast, reliable internet for just $49 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. Plus, find out how to get up to a $500 prepaid card with a qualifying bundle. Offer ends 10/23/2022. Restrictions apply. New Comcast Business 50 megabits per second internet customers only. Requires enrollment in EcoBill and AutoPay. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra and subject to change. Comcast Business Mobile utilizes the network with the most Root Metrics 5G data reliability wins in 1H 2022. Results may vary. Award is not an endorsement.
Clichés usually have some truth to them. Happy wife, happy life. The couple that plays together stays together. Communication is the key to overcoming hurdles in the relationship. So if you're suffering from symptoms of ED, you need to reach out to the Forge Medical Group. The board-certified medical director and team of physicians at Forge Medical Group now offers the revolutionary acoustic wave therapy, which uses sound waves to increase circulation, repair existing blood vessels, and even form new ones. Acoustic wave therapy from Forge Medical Group is safe, simple, and non-invasive, with no drugs, no surgery, no injections, and no side effects. Better yet, there's no downtime either. In fact, call today and you'll be back up to your old tricks in no time. Appointments fill up fast, so call Forge Medical Group now at 610-632-8181. That's 610-632-8181. ForgeMedicalGroup.com. Call 610-632-8181.
Hey guys, Bob Cooney here. Plan your game days at Live Casino and Hotel Philadelphia, the ultimate game day watch party headquarters, presented by Bud Light. Catch all the action at Sports and Social or Center Bar with giveaways, contests, and special alumni appearances. Sip on specialty cocktails at the Prime Rib. Try Philly favorites with a twist at Luck Fu, like cheesesteak egg rolls or the Philly Philly Roll. Plus, enjoy $5 Bud Lights every game. Game days at Live, presented by Bud Light. To learn more, visit livecasinophilly.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Fall is the in-between season. In between summer and winter. In between flip-flops and puffy parkas. And in between soaring heat and frigid cold. Which makes it the perfect season to upgrade your comfort with special financing offers and rebates on a new high-efficiency heating and cooling system from Trane. Including a whole-house air filtration system to keep the air you breathe clean and safe. Visit Trane.com to find an independent Delaware Valley Trane comfort specialist near you. It's hard to stop a Trane. Subject to credit approval. See dealer for details.
Auto Lenders is absolutely transparent about absolutely everything, like the fact that we know everybody hates commercials. So thanks for letting us interrupt your sports talk to talk about how incredibly good our cars are because we never get them from auctions. And for thinking about how awesome your sports radio will sound in the car you're about to get. We can talk more about it when you visit our new location in Fairless Hills. Visit autolenders.com.
Are you seeing the telomeres here? Come here, look at the scope.
Dr. Ocasio's lab startup incredible. Just discovered a gene therapy breakthrough.
The cells have already doubled.
He needs a fleet of research assistants before this breakthrough breaks them.
We need lab techs, research assistants.
Indeed can help him hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. We instantly connect you with quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job description. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
By the time you're finished listening to this Pepsi Zero Sugar, you'll be 15 seconds closer to kickoff. Stock up now because game day is so close, you can almost taste it. Football watching. Better with Pepsi.
Listen up as I talk Huntington Valley Bank with President Bob Marino, the GOAT. Fast-growing Huntington Valley Bank, best bank for your business, celebrating 150 years as a top contender in local banking.
Hey guys, Xandrew, I have something awesome to tell you about. You can tip off the NBA season with FanDuel in partnership with Valley Forge, right? You can make all your bets. It's America's number one sportsbook. And if you join today, you get $150 in free bets guaranteed when you place your first $5 bet. Just sign up with promo code Fanatic to sign up. Now, this is awesome. All customers that sign up get 3 months of NBA League Pass when they make a $5 bet on the NBA. That's it. So you make that $5 bet, you might win and get some money, but think about the value you're getting on a $5 bet. You're getting 3 months of NBA League Pass courtesy of FanDuel that you can watch all the action as you bet from everything. Moneyline, point spreads, totals, and of course, my favorite thing, the SGPs, and my favorite thing specifically with the SGPs, the three-point prop. Hit on one yesterday. It was a lot of fun. And when you win, you get your money instantly. So don't miss your chance to get $150 in free bets plus 3 months of NBA League Pass with promo code Fanatic. Make every moment more with FanDuel, the official sportsbook partner of the NBA. You got to be 21 plus and present in PA. On new customers, first online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonus issuers, knowledgeable free bets that expire 14 days after receipt. Existing customers, $5 NBA wager required. Limit one pass per customer across both offers. Restrictions apply. Void where prohibited. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem, call 1-800-GAMBLER.
More of the Anthony Gargano Show now
on 97.5 The Fanatic.
10 o'clock hour brought to you by Window Nation. Take advantage of Window Nation's 50% off sale on all style windows. Plus, make no down payment with no payments and no interest for 12 full months. Call 866-90-NATION or visit windownation.com. All right, welcome back. 10:30 across the Delaware Valley. By the way, tune in Sunday. We're going to do a little pregame fightin' action. You and I broadcasting live from Xfinity Live Sunday before game 5, 11 a.m. to 2:30.
I love this, right? Because I'm going to that game.
I am.
So too. The fact that, you know.
I don't have tickets yet, but I'm going to go.
You'll make it work.
I'm going to take my cousin.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, and then we just walk right across the street. Like, that's great, man.
Yeah, and we'll go. I'm excited. Listen, I just want to feel it. We're going Saturday night. The whole family. I can't wait. I can't wait. I want the kids to feel that vibe, to feel what it's going to be like. We're going to sit right in the outfield, cuz.
Oh, that's Saturday awesome. Night. That's great.
Me, Tam, and the boys.
Yeah, and they've never experienced that before, man. It's God. Crazy. It's been so long since they've been in the playoffs that they haven't even gotten a taste of it.
Yeah.
Have they been locked in? On TV?
Yesterday, yes.
Okay.
They were there. Yeah, the month before, we had the watch party.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Yeah.
The roast pork, nice.
Yeah, the roast pork. No, they've been...
That's all I think about.
Yeah, we had the roast pork. Time stopped at the Licio's and got the roast pork.
Oh, dude, strong move.
And then we had the roast pork sandwiches. They, I'm not on battle of that, all this nonsense. I want to watch the game. They all ate the food and everything.
I'm not going to not eat. You're crazy. You're you don't even eat. Starve yourself.
No, I'm
not going to not eat.
Not about that. I just want to want. I want to concentrate. I want to concentrate.
Oh, yeah. God forbid you chew. No, but that's going to take away from your concentration.
It's a hassle. It's a hassle.
Oh, I missed that pitch. I was chewing.
No, but you know what I'm saying. You got to concentrate. I'm too nervous to eat during a game. Like Eagle games and stuff like that, like big games. Nah, come on, bro. We got a big game tonight, Sixers, dude.
Yeah, man, Sixers Bucks. I can't wait to see this because, look, we didn't really watch right on Tuesday. It was tough. It was Philly's playoffs, right? So it's not like I was locked in. I watched the beginning portions of the game before the Phillies, first pitch started. But once the Phillies were on, I was locked in all Phillies, and then you watch the recaps and all that kind of stuff. So. This is our first chance to really dive in deep and watch the Sixers tonight. It's a big test. It's a home game. I know the Bucks are missing Chris Middleton and a couple of other players, so they're not going to have their full slate, but it's still Giannis. By the way, how about Ben yesterday? Minus 26, fouled out.
Dude, he was... I got to tell you, I loved it.
Oh, yeah, of course. I will hate watch all season long.
What a freaking... Bum.
There's people on their high horses that do the whole, he's not here anymore. Why do you care? Well, I'm going to hate watch.
You know what? He deserves it. He wanted out. He was a crybaby. He was a flaming jerk off. He deserves every bit of hate you get.
Exactly.
Stop it. I don't want to hear any of that nonsense. And I love it.
Yes.
And I love the fact that he sucked last night and that Brooklyn lost. Now, I'm kind of shook over that Boston loss. I ain't gonna lie.
All right.
I did not expect that. Now it's one game and it's early and the whole thing. I get all of it. But I need them to play defense and be tough. Like they got out rebounded. Like they got beat up.
Yeah, they got punched in the mouth. In Boston. Need to see Joe bounce back with all I heard was that he was mope. He was Mr. Mope game one. We can't be mope in game one.
Was he though?
A couple people told me that.
I know.
And I was just like, remember how we asked people like, "Hey, look, we were watching the Phillies. What was it like?" And a couple people were like, "Oh, he's moping around." Like, really?
I know.
Game
I don't
one?
Understand that. I don't. Do you understand that?
No.
I don't get that either.
He got in a little, scrum with Marcus Smart.
Yeah, but
that
was a normal thing. He reached for his shoe, and even Joe was acting. And I don't think he's moping. I don't know. I wanted to dive into it after the Phillies game,
And then I watched, I was watching Lakers Warriors, and then I went, let me watch the Sixers, and then I fell
asleep. By the way, the Lakers are a joke, man.
They stick. You know, also a joke, the Spurs.
Yep.
They're tanking big time. They're in tank mode.
By the way, one more thing we got to mention for tonight. Got a little playoff action. Got a little playoff action versus Cincy. The Go Union.
That's right.
That's screen. That's on a screen. Union Sixers tonight.
On screen. Yes. What time? So I got to map out everything.
I believe it's 8 o'clock. So let me check the old Union schedule.
Yeah, I need to. I need
8
to
o'clock.
Map. All right, 7:30 Sixers.
Yep.
8 o'clock Union. And I'm kind of locked into this baseball, too, to be honest with you.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I watched Yankees Astros last night. Because I'm in this mode of, you know, I think I still believe they can win this thing and they get the World Series, dude. I want a World Series bad.
So bad.
I got to tell you this. I always should say this, but the gift of a good baseball team. Like, when your baseball team's good, it's such a gift, right? And, man, I mean, the last 2 weeks have been a blast.
Oh, it's been so much fun.
Oh, my God.
And this time of year, right, because you got the new seasons kicking off with basketball and hockey. Flies, and, of course, when your football team's good, too, right?
6-0 good.
Well, so happy it's the bye week. I never love bye weeks, right? So happy it's the bye week so I can just be locked in on the fills.
I know, dude. Well, by the way, is it not fantastic Sunday?
Sunday, 2 o'clock.
Like we're broadcasting live from Xfinity Live on a Sunday, but it's a baseball Sunday.
Yeah, man.
A bye week.
I'm going to be a problem on Sunday.
Here's what I believe. It's going to be 2-2 going into Sunday.
You think so?
Yeah.
Dude.
2-2 Sunday, we go into wheels up.
Okay.
I'm happy with that.
I like that.
Aren't you? Don't you feel good? 2-2, wheels up. Like I do believe that.
And then you showed that you've already been able to win on the road in a couple of rounds, right? All of them. You won both in St. Louis, one in Atlanta.
Split. I mean, and again, you just need to win one of those two.
And it's a little Nola revenge factor after his album.
Right. I was thinking the same thing.
Like Nola struggling yesterday does not make me go to, oh no, he's back. Like that, I don't get to that.
No, I don't think that either. I don't think so either. I'm a little disappointed. I wanted the...
Of course.
You know, it was
There's no excuse for that.
It was Cliff Lee-like.
Yeah.
Right? Where you got to be able to... Come on, man. You got to shut down the league. When you got a 4-0 the league, you got to make that stand up.
Yeah, absolutely.
And maybe it's because I believed... Like, I believe in Nola. Like, I was shocked. Like, when they're up 4-0... I mean, I was doing the World Series dance, dude. I hate to say it. I was dancing on my own.
Let's go work at you.
I was World Series.
We're going streaky!
That's the only reason why, dude. That's the only reason why the only reason why I'm a little bummed out today is because I was high, man. Weren't you high?
Yeah, of course
I was.
You're
not texting.
I wasn't working.
I mean, we were high, dude. I was floating yesterday. They were up 4-0. When you hear Johnny Decay, that's all that is. Everybody was sky high thinking, you know, 2-0. That's all that is. Everybody be back tomorrow, man. Got to get this one. Just got to purge it out of your system. And we come back Friday, tomorrow, for game 3.
Yeah, here, let me just...
Let
me just play this for you.
We ain't losing.
All right.
Yeah.
Come on, man. It's not like that confidence went away.
They're
probably sitting in their locker room going, we got this. We can't come back home. Tied at one, just like we did against Atlanta.
I like it.
We just need
like
to win one extra game. That's all.
Yep. That's great. That's great. Let's go to T. Will. You're on 97.5 The Fanatic. T. Will!
Yo, cuz. Chudas, what's happening?
You believe it?
Yeah, absolutely.
We ain't losing.
Listen, no worries. You got a West Coast team coming to this chilly East Coast. And those bats aren't going to be alive like they got hot last night. So there's no worries. You got to understand this, too. The Phillies didn't give up either. They, you know, Reese hits the home run. JT hits the single. Now you got Bryce up. You know, you had the perfect scenario. So it's not like they quit. You know, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You, like you said, you're going to purge. You want to get it out. You get the win tomorrow night. And, you know, you look to Saturday.
Yes. Yes. That's it, man. You know what? Yep. I want to be, does this make sense? I just want to be 2-2 come Sunday with wheels
on. No, stay greedy. You want 3-1. Stay greedy.
All right. You
stay
got
greedy.
It.
Hey, listen, though. We got to talk about our Sixers, man.
Yeah.
Someone told me I'm overreacting over one loss. Well, it's not about just one loss. It's the loss to the Boston Celtics. And it seems like since we've had Joel Embiid in 2014, this team has punched us in the freaking mouth constantly.
I know.
Constantly. And whoever told Chunas that Embiid was lazy, he was. He played lazy that game. Lazy.
No,
passes.
Mopey. He said mopey.
Lazy mopey. It's all the same.
What I saw, too, and, you know, see what you think of this. Is he, again, he put the ball on the floor a lot. Like, he got the ball taken from him a lot.
Up at the elbow, giving him a double team at the elbow, and you have no angle to pass out of that.
Yeah.
If you want to get doubled on the block where you can see the court.
Yeah, well, we know.
You can't see the court. You can't see the court from the elbow getting double teamed like that.
Yeah.
That was not the same team we saw in the preseason.
Yeah, I was surprised at how they looked. Like that. I really was, I'll be honest with you. I expected a much better, different look out of them, you know?
Yeah, you didn't let Maxi get off to the fourth quarter. You had Harden dribbling just constantly. There was no movement.
Yeah, but Harden looked good. Here's the problem. Joe's six turnovers, again, is huge. Right?
That's, no, you're not going to win a game with 14 turnovers going into the third quarter.
Nah.
It's not happening. Hey, listen, man, it's a 4-point line tonight, and that tells me that's a 6-year line.
4 points tonight. Yeah, I would agree with that.
You know, but the Sixers don't play good on TNT either. So, I mean, like, which way are you going?
Yes, I agree with that. I go Sixers in that.
I like it, man. Listen, they got to come home. They got to get that bad taste in Boston out of their mouth.
I think this team's good. They got to get used to playing with each other. They got a new bench. You know, one game, and it's an NBA season. I mean, it's October, right?
Like, a long season.
Exactly.
And, it's just the fact that it was Boston, and you know how we hate Boston.
Yeah, well, that's why I got the sour. I got the bad taste because of that.
Right. Right.
But other than that, T-Will, I agree with you.
Yo, listen, man. Let's have a good Philly weekend. Get Philly up.
Yes,
stop
right.
You're being mopey right now.
I'm not being mopey. I might be mopey.
Chunas, keep them happy, Chunas.
Of course, man. Go on now.
You're the man.
Talk to you soon.
See you, buddy. Am I being mopey?
No, you're not being mopey.
Am I being like Joe? I'm gonna be a mopey.
No, I don't think you're being a mope. I think
I'm a
you
little
know,
bummed
you're...
over the. I was greedy.
I was. I mean, look, I was bummed out too. I was so disappointed.
I can't come in. Like if I come in today, balls to the wall. You know. I mean, I gotta feel it. I don't feel balls to the wall today.
I'm feeling it.
You do?
Yeah, man.
I don't know, but like
we're talking about the clinching game, Game 5 on Sunday when we do the show together.
All right, well, that's tomorrow, though. Like, tomorrow I'll be balls to the wall. Don't you have a rhythm?
Oh, I have no rhythm. Don't invite me to your wedding. I got no rhythm.
Like, to me, you know, I'm a little more subdued today, and then tomorrow we get nuts in preparation for Game 3. You know what I mean?
I hear you. I listen.
Like,
I got you.
Know, I just go, let me get the bad taste. I got, you know, the last couple of days, right? We had that Sixer loss, and then yesterday with Nola being up. I'm like, you know, I'm not shook. It's just not going to be, you know, I don't want to be a mope, but I can't be like I was yesterday. I mean, I was losing my mind yesterday. I mean, there's got to be a difference day to day, no matter what happened, right? Right or wrong?
I understand. Sorry, dealing with some technical stuff here.
Oh, all right.
But no, I mean, look, I get it. I don't blame anybody for being bummed out. Look, I was bummed out. Like, they're up 4-0. They lose that game.
That's all. I mean, it's, again, that doesn't mean I don't think they
can. But I love what T. Will said. He's not wrong. They did have opportunities to come back. That game against the Braves, the second game where Hoskins misplays the ground ball, they're down 3-0. They look like they were happy to leave Atlanta with a split. Right, like there was not much life after that Hoskins misplay, and I even thought that all the vibes were gone. That wasn't the case yesterday, right? They still had opportunities. You had the home run from Reese, Bryce with the big double, and Bryce was trying to fire up the team. So yeah. I'm like, all right, there's definitely life.
This team it believes in itself now. These dudes believe in themselves. They're not looking to turtle up.
No,
I don't believe that at all. They got fighting them. Listen, we're going to look back at some point in the roaring 20s. I don't know how deep or whatever, but I do believe there will be a parade, whether it's this year, next year, or at some point, we'll look back. And the moment we'll look to is that Cardinals series.
Yeah, the ninth inning specifically.
Ninth inning.
Yep.
And that's when they got belief. And I look at this team, and they believe in themselves, and they're confident, and they feel good about themselves. So, you know, like that I feel good about, dude. But I can't be, like, I don't want to be mopey, but I can't be Mr., you know, today. Like, even though that makes me feel good.
Come on, man.
By the way.
Ranger Danger.
Ranger Danger.
Come on, man. You don't want to mess with him.
According to Sam Carcini, Flyers are going to open the doors to the Wells Fargo Center for ticket holders early on Sunday so fans can watch the Phillies at 2:37.
Oh, that's cool.
All right? That's going to be on a big screen. And fans can enter with tickets to Flyers San Jose. Remember, that game's at 7 o'clock.
Yeah.
$5 beer, $1 dog.
Whoa, that's awesome.
Dude, that's a great idea.
That is so smart. Look, John Tortorella comes in, and look, now we got good ideas. It's not just gritty apps anymore. That's a great idea.
That's a great idea.
I let the teams coming together.
So you come in, you watch the baseball game at 2:30.
$5 a beer, you're getting that anywhere. Right? You go anywhere in the city, you're spending more than $5. It's actually not a bad deal.
No, it's a good deal. $5 beer, $1 hot dogs.
Dude,
that's a good day. And by the way, you go watch the game, right? So you watch Phillies Pods. And you're around for some Flyers Sharks. That's good. That's a great doubleheader, too.
That's a really good idea by the Wells Fargo Center. You got to love that, man.
Yeah, man. Good stuff. I like that a lot. That's a fun. I like the communal viewing.
Oh, so much. That's why, you know, you and I have talked about this before. There's a touch of jealousy for me in Toronto.
Yeah, the Weave in North.
Yeah, I mean, that's really cool.
Being outside like that, you know. I'm with you, dude. I've always wanted that.
Yeah, so I think that's a really good idea.
Yeah.
By the way, dude.
That's good stuff, yes.
We got the vault coming up next. I can't wait for it.
Really?
Yeah, dude.
You've been chirping about
this vault. Yeah, I'm chirping about this vault. It's totally different.
Wow, you're freaking me out.
Yeah, man, it's different.
You're gonna get me nuts?
I don't know if it's getting you nuts. It's just I can't wait to do it.
What do you mean? You're not going to get, like, what reaction am I going to have?
I think it's more enjoyment. It's not, there's no game today for the Phillies, so it's not a game day serious vibe.
Okay. So more amusing?
More amusing, yes.
Yeah, you know, I get serious on game days.
Yeah, I know, but it's not game day for the Phillies. It's game day Sixers, so yes. Still serious, and game day Union, so still serious, but.
Yes.
But come on now.
I want to get nuts Sixers now. I want the building to rock tonight for the Sixers.
I will be for sure.
All right. Let's take a quick tee up. 610-632-0975. 610-632-0975. I hate the Bucks too. Bucks. Bleep the Bucks.
Shoot the deer, man.
Let me tell you about the Bet Parks app. Yeah, the Bet Parks app is fantastic. I'm telling you about it all the time, man. It's fantastic. And on a Bet Parks Thursday, forget about it. All right, I know that you go, oh, the Phillies are off, but guess what? Sixers, after one thing you know they're going to do is they're going to fill it up, right? T-Will said it. I think he's right. That's a Sixer line tonight.
Lay it.
Same game parlays. Bet Parks has that. You also got Thursday night football between the Saints and Arizona. You got that. You got the Yankees and the Astros. I got to go back to the Astros. You got all kinds of good stuff. And, of course, you know, even though it's a Eagles bye, you got Sunday, NFL, Saturday, college. Make sure you get the Bet Parks app. It's the best, more than just the score. Player performances for baseball, football, hockey, hoops. It's all there. And in fact, new customers get a risk. How about this? You get up to $750 of site credit if your first bet is not a winner. So check it out. It's the Bet Parks app. The code is Fanatic. You got to be in Pennsylvania or New Jersey. You got to be 21. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Fanatic Sports Update.
Series tied at 1. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this update is brought to you by Whole Foods Market. Save big at Whole Foods Market. Organic Honey Crisp apples are just $3.49 per pound through October 25th. While supplies last, Prime members save an extra 10%. Promo varies by location. See app for details. The Phillies dropped Game 2 in San Diego yesterday. Yeah, that's a tough one. You don't want to lose in the playoffs, but it is a 1-1 series tie right now, and the Phillies return home. Game 3 will be tomorrow. Ranger Suarez gets the start. He'll go up against Joe Musgrove, so hopefully the Phillies can get back into their winning ways and maybe win in 5. That would be nice. It was a tough one yesterday, though. Aaron Nola had a 4-run lead, blew it, and Phillies ended up losing. The Sixers are back in action tonight. Tip-off at 7:30. You can listen live right here on the Fanatic. It is the home opener for the Sixers. They host the Milwaukee Bucks, and the Union start their cup run tonight at 8 o'clock against Cincinnati. This update is also brought to you by New Look Home Design. Need a new roof? Call New Look Home Design. Save 50% on all roofing projects and qualify for no payments, no interest financing for 12 months. Visit newlookhomedesign.com or call 800-279-5300. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this is 97.5 The Fanatic.
It's the Cuz, Anthony Gargano. Weekdays 10 to 2 on 97.5 The Fanatic.
1-877 Cars for Kids. KARS Cars for Kids. 1-877 Cars for Kids. Donate your car today. 1-877 Cars for Kids. KARS Cars for Kids. 1-877 Cars for Kids. Donate your car today.
Donate your car today at carsforkids.org. That's cars with a K. Your car, running or not, can be picked up as soon as the next day. You'll get a maximum tax deduction and a vacation voucher.
1-877 Cars for Kids. KARS Cars for Kids. 1-877 Cars for Kids. Donate your car today.
Now accepting donations of land, homes, buildings, or any kind of real estate.
Hey, it's John Kincaid from my friends at Window Nation, and you know forecasters are presenting a colder, snowier winter than we've had in the last couple years. That's why Window Nation wants you to put your wallet away until 2025. What are you talking about, John? We got to pay for the windows. Yeah, you do, but you don't pay for them until 2025. It's a great deal. You're going to buy 2 windows, you're going to get 2 free, and you're going to pay nothing until 2025. I'm talking no money down, no payments, no interest. Window Nation's got you covered. But John, they probably don't have my size of a window. Yes, they do. They have every size, every style, every color that you could ever imagine. You go to windownation.com and you do the window shopping online, and you're going to find exactly what you're looking for. Did you know their average installer has over 16 years experience? Do you know they got an A+ rating from the Better Business Bureau? All you know is that if you buy 2 windows, you get 2 free, and they're going to charge you nothing until 2025. What a great deal. Buy 2, get 2 free, but you got to do it now. Go to windownation.com and do your window shopping, then call them. 866-90-NATION. That's 866-90-NATION.
Hey guys, Bob Cooney here. Tip off the NBA season with FanDuel in partnership with Valley Forge, America's number one sports book. Join today to get $150 in free bets, guaranteed when all you have to do is place a $5 first bet. Sign up with promo code Bob to sign up. All customers get 3 months of NBA League Pass when they make a $5 bet on the NBA, courtesy of FanDuel. Then you can watch all the action as you bet on everything from the money line to point spreads to totals. And best of all, you'll get your winnings instantly. So don't miss your chance to get $150 in free bets plus 3 months of NBA League Pass with promo code Bob. Make every moment more with FanDuel, official sportsbook partner of the NBA.
21 plus and present PA. New customers first online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonus issued as non-withdrawable free bets that expire in 14 days. Existing customers, $5 NBA wager required. Limit one pass per customer across both offers. Restrictions apply. Void where prohibited. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Hey, to become the next generation of innovators, entrepreneurs, and creators, we're going to need something.
Like a high-speed internet connection that can turn my ideas into reality.
Like the skills to become the world's most powerful coder.
Like the tools to start my sustainable shoe business.
You just heard some of the millions of students Comcast is supporting through Project Up, our comprehensive initiative and $1 billion commitment to open doors for the next generation so they can build a future of unlimited possibilities. Learn more at Comcast.com/Project Up.
At my age, I never dreamed I'd be dealing with opioid addiction.
I was pregnant and I couldn't stop.
Getting sidelined by an injury was bad, but the cravings were way worse.
Then I heard about 844-REACH-NJ.
They connected me to treatment and I had a healthy baby.
844-REACH-NJ was the call that made the difference.
Thank goodness I made the call.
So glad I made the call for both of us.
REACH-NJ.
If you or someone you love is struggling with addiction, call 844-REACH-NJ from the New Jersey Department of Human Services.
Let me guess. Unknown caller? You could reduce the number of unwanted calls and emails with online privacy protection. The latest innovation from Discover. We'll help regularly remove your personal info, like your name and address, from 10 popular people search websites that could sell your data. And we'll do it for free. Activate in the Discover app. See terms and learn more at discover.com/online privacy protection.
The best part about taking ZzzQuil Pure Z's Sleep Plus Next Day Energy at night is actually the next morning. I wake up alert with none of the grogginess from taking too much melatonin. Pure Z Sleep Plus Next Day Energy is a bilayer tablet with immediate release melatonin and extended release B vitamins to help me fall asleep naturally and wake refreshed. It's my secret weapon for a great night's sleep and a great morning.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Can't beat that.
ZzzQuil Pure Z's Gummies. Sleep better, wake your best.
Visit Barlow Chevrolet this fall and receive discounts below MSRP on select vehicles in stock. Competitive financing rates are also available to well-qualified buyers through GM Financial. New vehicles like Equinox, Silverado, and Malibu are arriving daily, so now is the time to reserve yours. At Barlow, we will always order the vehicle you want with no additional dealer fees or markups. It's our goal to keep the buying process simple, convenient, and hassle-free. This fall, find new roads at Barlow Chevrolet in Delran or at BarlowChevrolet.com.
Hey guys, it's Andrew. You want to make up to $825 this month? Well, here's how you do it at CSL Plasma. You donate plasma at any of CSL Plasma's Tri-State Area Donation Centers and you get money right in your pocket. Reloadable prepaid card for doing a good deed. That's awesome. Plasma donations, they help create therapies to treat patients with rare and serious diseases, and donations are needed now more than ever. The donation process, it's a lot like donating blood, right? You've done that before. It's nice and simple, but you're getting a nice chunk of change in your pocket when you're done as a thank you for your time. And the beauty about CSL Plasma is you don't need an appointment to donate, okay? Walk-ins are welcome at all Tri-State Area Donation Centers, including in North Philly, West Philly, Northeast Philly, Yaden, Aramingo, Hamilton and Maple Shade, New Jersey, and Newark, Delaware. So you're covered in PA, Jersey, and Delaware. Saving lives, it's never been easier or more rewarding, right? You're going to feel good about yourself, of course, but you're also making $825. When you donate plasma, you do the amazing. For location information and to learn more about the plasma donation process, just download the CSL Plasma app or visit cslplasma.com. That's cslplasma.com. Tell them Andrew sent you when you go. CSL Plasma, good for you, great for life.
WPEN Burlington, Philadelphia, a Beasley Media Group station, home of the most entertaining sports talk in Philadelphia. 97.5 The Fanatic, Philadelphia.
Welcome back. 11 o'clock across the Delaware Valley. Don't feel good. Once we get to Sixers tip-off tonight, go beat the Bucks. We're streaky. I want to get back on the winning side. Tunis.
Yeah. Feel good. Look, the Flyers have done that for us. They're 3-0.
Three and one.
3-1. If the Sixers can get back into it today with a win, and you got the Union at 8 o'clock, you take those vibes, carry them into to tomorrow.
I think it's key. I expect the Union to win, and I expect the Sixers to win. So those two win, that brings the good vibes to the Ranger. I need the Ranger tomorrow. Yeah, really. I want the bats.
Ranger danger. You don't want to mess around with Ranger danger.
Ranger danger. Here you go. Here are some. I gave you the numbers. Lifetime, because I believe in the lifetime. Here's Musgrove. You ready? Phil's against Musgrove. How about this? Kraft singles, has a home run and a double.
Yeah, I feel like we've been hearing that a lot about these pitchers, but
lifetime against Musgrove.
It's just not happening with the Phillies, which is kind of disappointing.
Castellanos, 5-for-18.
All right, well, that's good.
All right, home run and a double. Bryce, 3-for-14, 7 Ks.
It means he's due.
Reese, 0-for-8.
Yeah.
Marsh, 1-for-2. JT, 2-for-11. But one of them was a home run.
Okay.
Schwarber, 2-for-16.
Oh, wow, that's interesting.
But one was a home run. Gene, 5-for-15. Stott, 1-for-2. That's it.
I wonder, let me check. Does Musgrove have the old reverse splits? Lefties have some tough numbers.
3-for-14, Bryce, 7 strikeouts. Schwarb, 2-for-16, 8 strikeouts. Wow.
In his career, righties hit 240 off him, lefties hit 243. Oh, it's actually pretty split right down the middle.
Yeah, but look at his strikeouts, though.
Same amount of home runs. Strikeouts righties 432, lefties 420 in his career. Actually, not... That's interesting.
Yeah, but the fact that he's a right-hander and he's able to strike out left-handers, like,
right?
You know,
look, he's a hell of a pitcher.
He is. No, I mean, obviously. Anyway,
gotta check the ears. Make sure there's nothing on there.
Here you go. The Ranger danger. Alfaro, 1-for-8.
By the way, I don't know why I found it so funny. Did you see him just eating an apple?
Yeah, in the dugout yesterday. Yeah. Bell, 1-for-8 with a home run. Cronenworth, 0-for-2. Drury, 0-for-1. Grisham, 1-for-4. Kim, 1-for-3. Manny, 1-for-2. Where are we at? Nola, 2-for-4. Profar, 1-for-5. Where's the Soto? Oh, there you go. Soto, 0-for-8 against the Ranger. That's good. You like that? 0-for-8.
Yeah, you have to.
All right, let me get back to the lines. Where are we at? Let's go to Jamie. You're on 97.5 The Fanatic. Jamie!
Cuz!
What's going on, Jamie?
That was a better after your hour intro, man. You're feeling the vibe a little bit. But you got to feel me, man. Feel it.
Yes.
Playoff baseball, man. Let's not worry about them numbers. Let's remember last weekend. Oh, a memorable one. One we'll tell our grandkids about.
Yes.
Phillies come home after 17 days on the road.
Friday was a great day.
Oh, my God. You can feel it. Like you said, that's what you want the boys. You want your family to feel on Sunday.
Yeah, I'm taking
it. Friday night.
Yep.
And we got all day to prep. All day in the parking lot. All day to talk. All day to build up.
Now, something I want to
mention. We know it's like choice wine. Choice wine. Bottle it up. Let's bottle this up. Let's enjoy it. We didn't expect to be here. We're playing with house money. But now that we're here to play. And they're coming home.
We ain't losing. We ain't losing, Jamie.
Hey, got a question. Cuz. You bring out the super chicken onto the field. There's always been a debate. What's the greatest mascot in sports? Oh, the San Diego chicken. Oh, he's so great. Oh, look at him dance. You bring out the fanatic. They battle it out. That crowd will be going
fanatic over the game.
I like it. Listen, I'm down with that. You could definitely. I'm with beating up the chicken. Get a chicken out. I'm down with that. In fact, we should do that tomorrow, Tunis. Yeah, I'd choke the chicken, man. I'm with you, James.
Or better yet, the goose. The goose. I hear all about the goose. Where's the goose? Cuz.
I like it,
James. Right. You're right, though, bud. Nola, right? 4-0. You're up 4-0. You served two high pitches. They got some hitters. Now it's 4-2. 0-2 counts. They kept getting pitches to hit. We got to bury him. And yeah, Ranger.
You got to kill him.
Ranger, he's infantry. He's going to be on his belly. He's going to be burying that ball into the dirt, and they're going to be swinging over it.
I like you, James. I like you. You're bringing good vibes, James.
That was awesome.
Good vibes.
I appreciate
Excellent call, James. Excellent. Thank you, buddy. That was good. I'm down with it. You know, we could choke the chicken. You can bury the chicken.
Hey, man.
All right. I know you're dying for the vault, so I'm dying for the vault. Open it, Tunis.
You know, when we began opening this vault nearly 2 hours ago, we had no real idea what we'd find inside. As it turns out, we haven't found very much.
All right. Hey, Ant, so this will be the first time really in the vault where I've basically just cut the music. Now, I'll set it up, but I needed to do something different today. Change the mojo up after the loss yesterday. We talked about it briefly at the end of the show. You saw what Jason Kelsey and Lane Johnson and Jordan Mailata are doing, correct?
Yes.
With the Christmas album.
They are doing a Christmas song. Right, Christmas album.
It's a Christmas album. It's coming out December 23rd, two days before Christmas, one day before
the Eagles-Cowboys.
And there's all the hype in the world, right? They're 6-0, so this thing's going to be bought hot and heavy.
Yeah, it's huge.
So let me just first, in case people haven't heard it yet, before I explain what the vault is today, I just want to play. This is the clip that they posted yesterday as the preview to their album. It's Jason Kelsey, Jordan Mailata, Lane Johnson. Connor Barwin's a part of it because he's friends with the band War on Drugs, so they're helping out the production value of it.
That's awesome.
It's really
I love
cool.
The War on Drugs.
So here's a little taste of Santa Claus coming to town.
Fantastic.
So that's going to be really cool.
Are you kidding me?
Like, that's going to be awesome. And we know that Jordan Mailata can actually sing, right? Like, that's really cool. So, Ant, I thought about this yesterday before I did the deep dive into the vault. I wanted to find all of our other former or current Philadelphia athletes
who had music
careers.
You're the best. You're the best.
So why not?
The greatest.
Let's start with Jules.
A little leaking in the streets. AI.
So here's one of Iverson's, one of his raps. We have a couple of raps. We have country music. And we have
Brett Myers.
And we have some group singing, but we'll start off with Iverson.
Buddy's watching you.
I had a rough night. Slept on $10,000 bills. Wake up to fake every day was real. So I keep focused on the mill. Wanna put me back in the streets to rob, hustle, steal, and kill. Only pen you catch me in is on the campus. Ducking the law cause we in some they never saw. 2000 Bentley sitting on 20 inches, instant attention. Mention my name, the whole storm start drenching. I plan to die with millions on top of millions. Keep my paper building for my two children. You only live once, so I'm balling records.
Jules! Listen to Jules!
So there's Alan.
That was the best. I'll never forget doing it. When that dropped,
yes,
that was like a big deal. Leave him leaking in the streets.
So as you can imagine, during the last break, I said, hey, I got to go and edit a little bit. Because, you know, we have a couple other songs that have some cuss words in it. What genre do you want to go to next, Ant?
Listen, I love this, dude. This is the greatest. I don't care. Just
all right, well, then I'll stick with the Sixers, okay? And this one, I'll be honest, not bad. When he was still playing with the Sixers, Meek did a song with Lou Williams.
Yeah.
So I remember listening to this. Yeah, so this was Meek's song, I Want It All, featuring Lou Williams.
It goes nothing.
Oh, I remember this. Yeah. Yeah.
I must be Maserati dreaming. I can't sleep at night. I wake up, I say my prayers. Thank God I live my life. I'm in a Gran Turismo 2-tone. Passengers are red bone. She's like the car, cause she can never keep her top on. See, yeah, I was sleeping in class, missing the lessons. I was millionaire dreaming. Passing these tests. My teachers used to say I was lazy and second guess me. Now I'm laughing at they ass, blowing cash and counting blessings. I understood the SATs. Yeah, okay, but what about these $1 million, these luxury Benz guts? Them Escalades on 26, them tires, they thin cut. You mean to tell me pass up steak and lobster for school lunch? Come on. I made my first meal, told moms I was leaving home. Then I made 30 more. Damn, I was putting on. I used to dollar menu and spectate at the mall, but now I'm buying that out. Cause I want it out.
Wasn't bad by Lou Will.
No, Lou Will good. No, listen, it wasn't bad at all. I remember that. That was actually pretty decent.
All right, we'll do one more rap song until we'll change the genre. This one actually was recent, 2 years ago. So he wasn't with the he was in L.A. So it made sense. DeSean Jackson put out a song 2 years ago.
D-Jax.
So here's D-Jax.
All my life been playing ball, push the point and push the rock. Rock in my left hand, bet I never fall off. Game time, I'm a ball. I'm a playmaker, then I just fall back. Pockets on swole, what you call that? Million man march on my back. Ain't no slacking off. We ain't none of that. Ballin' in the game is where they catch me at. Wrists all gold, but it's petite. Bodies, Instagram models, all freaks. Freaks.
Hold up, I've been doing too much. Now these
Touchdown.
Not as good as Lil Will.
Beat, Lil Will way better.
Beat was nice.
I still go AI over greater than D-Jax.
Yes, I agree with you. All right, so those were the rap songs that we have for you.
That's clear.
All right, so let's go old school, back on the vinyl days. With Dave Schultz.
Oh, yes. The penalty box.
Baby, how long will you keep me in the penalty box? Baby, I know, but it's lonely in the penalty box. I know I broke the rules, but rules are broken by fools. Baby, how long will you keep me in the penalty box? Love is like an ice hockey game. Sometimes it can be rough. Girl, you got me so all aflame. I never, never get enough. You got me charging and cooking, holding and hooking. And then you blow the whistle on me. When you gonna let me go free? Don't you know how slow go the penalty clocks with their tickety-tocks in the penalty box?
Oh my God, that's hysterical, dude.
I love it, man.
Oh, that's great. That is priceless.
So there's Schultz, the hammer, the hound, excuse me, with the vinyl. And now,
oh my God. You know, it's so like, you know, that time period,
yes.
You know, whatever, but it works. You know what I mean? In a weird way. Like you could say that down Wildwood at one of those nightclubs.
Oh, it's great.
Like comedy night, like 2-drink minimum.
All right, you're going to probably want to take your headphones off but because of the, it's the beauty of the vault, you have to listen to it. Here's your boy Brett Myers with his country career that he's got going. You still listening?
I got my girl riding shotgun. I'm going to drink this town tonight.
He's still with us?
Those lyrics sound familiar.
Oh, my God. Okay, so I got...
You see, like, every lyrics, all those lyrics are the same.
Yeah,
the same,
about
right?
Drinking and all that kind of stuff, yeah. All right, so I got two left for you. This one, not
got
a...
my dog, I got my beer. I got my gun, I got my beer. I got my girl, I got my beer. I got my beer, I got my beer.
There you go. Yeah, he's gonna drink the town tonight. All right, two more. This one, not a musical career. This one, more of an assist. When I say the name Natalie Gilbert, does that ring a bell?
Natalie Gilbert? No idea.
Well, she needed some help. And Mo Cheeks came to the rescue.
Ah, that's beautiful.
Starlight's last dream.
Last gleaming. Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fire. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
That's awesome, man.
Good for Mo,
man. That was one of the greatest things ever. Him doing that.
Yeah, that was, I mean.
That was beautiful.
Could you imagine? That must have sucked to have been her. And here comes Mo Cheeks, the helping hand. So not so much a musical
career.
You never
know when you have a brain cramp.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, on a stage like that. All right, last one, Ant. This one's a little bit longer, which is why I wanted to save the best for last. The group. Your 1988 Philadelphia Eagles, and Buddy's watching you.
Ah, what are the classics, dude?
My favorite part is Zendejas. It's just awful. But here's Buddy's watching you.
Home Brown with a lot to say. I back it up by the way I play. Guys, look at me, they know what to do. I see, look out, and I'm coming on the through.
Randall Cunningham, quarterback, the guy everybody wants to sell. Now you see me, now you don't. You think you will? No, you won't.
Pick six, wide receiver. They got the names of jokes, but I made them all believe. I go up, guys, all around. Who's got the ball when we hit the ground?
Buddy's watching you.
He's watching.
Yes, he's watching.
And the
I kick field goals. Am I nervous? Yeah, I suppose. To win the game by hitting the mark, this game's over before it starts.
Keith Jackson, tight end.
Yeah, boy!
Yeah, boy!
You feel I'm bad and bold, but the best thing about me, I got hands of gold.
Reggie White, defensive end. Hit quarterbacks like a command sin. Like a good minister, when I'm thin, I help them up and say, God bless you!
Wow. Dude, that's outrageous.
Oh, I was looking forward to this since yesterday.
That is outrageous. That's hysterical. What a great idea. I love the vault. Hey, I want you to look at two more.
Okay.
All right. So Santa, South Philly Santa says that Dick Allen had a song.
Oh, is that right?
And Joe Frazier, I know, had a song.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
That's fabulous. This, what a great idea. I know I'm missing others.
Well, yeah, and I was trying to ask Russ if Ricky was here this morning, and John Brazier came in. I was like, any other former Phillies? Because you know all the Phillies players probably.
Phillies, well, ain't no stopping. I got to hear that again, too.
Oh, yeah, Phillies, of course. But they weren't the ones singing it.
No, I know. It was McPhee.
But yeah. I'm sure a couple of Phillies players had some awful country albums other than just Brett Myers.
Well, I mean, Tug McGraw was the father, right?
Yeah.
Tim, I wonder, I think there was got to be someone that, like, there's got to be somebody else.
I'm
right?
sure people could tweet in some more options.
That is fabulous.
Oh, Philly Sports for Life just tweeted in, get my Michael Phelps on.
Oh, the best. The best.
Oh, man. It's
Jim
beautiful.
McMahon. T. Will says Jim McMahon.
Well, he was, didn't he do the Bears one?
I don't know. He said he had one with the Eagles.
Is that right?
I don't remember it.
Okay.
I gave him my Michael Phelps on. Michael Phelps. Oh, that was the greatest. You used to play that all the time. I said, die laughing. You got to get that too, dude. Okay. That's a great one. Now, I always wanted to do our old Christmas album. And now we got those guys doing it. I love it.
Yeah.
610-632-0975. Back to the phones coming up next. 610-632-0975. It's Cuz Radio with the Tunis. Wow. What a day, man. What a day. All right. We're going to get back in there. I got to get back in the mode. Let's talk a little bit about your kitchen. And let me tell you about Colonial Marble and Granite now for a second. Because it was funny. The other night, my family room's right off the kitchen. And, you know, so I had like my father came over, my nephew Joseph, Tooch came over, and everybody's coming over, and, you know, Tam made roast pork sandwiches like the Tunis told you. And she, I hear about the kitchen. I don't want everybody to come over. I can't even do anything with this kitchen. This kitchen's horrible. Tunis, what does she say? This kitchen.
That's right, it stinks.
Yeah. Yeah. That's it. So, therefore, thank you, Nikos, president and owner of Colonial Marble and Granite. And here's what I find out, and we're going to be going through the process. I'll tell you all about it because I think it can help you guys. They're more than countertops at Colonial Marble and Granite. They have a design team, in fact, headed by Sandra. Sandra is awesome. She's incredible. They do all these in-home consultations to help with choosing your remodel, everything you can imagine. Countertops, cabinetry, tile, flooring, lighting. I mean, you name it. It's a one-stop shop taking care of their customers from selection to installation. And now during their fall into savings sale, you can save 20% off all marble, granite, quartz countertops, kitchen cabinetry. Get a fully installed kitchen sink and faucet baggage for just $499. Check out their area showrooms over the weekend and get 25% off all tile. Get tremendous savings now and have a new kitchen in time for the holidays. Financing, no worries. Get zero money down. 0% financing on purchases of $19.99 or more for up to 18 months. Fall into savings now. One of their local showrooms or online at colonialmarble.net.
Fanatic Sports Update.
Series tied at one. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this update is brought to you by teethkeepers.com. Dental and vision plans for everyone starting at under $8 a month at teethkeepers.com. Go to teethkeepers.com and enroll today. Phillies dropped game two to the Padres yesterday. They had a 4-0 lead, but Aaron Nola was a tough outing. Him and Brad Hand combined, giving up 7 earned runs. So the Phillies lose game two. Series tied at 1-1 apiece. They're off today, and they're back tomorrow in South Philadelphia. Games 3, 4, and 5, all at Citizens Bank Park. Ranger Suarez gets a start in game 3 for the Fightins. He'll go up against Joe Musgrove. Tonight we have Sixers action, 7:30 tip-off, their home opener. They host the Milwaukee Bucks. You can listen live right here on the Fanatic. And the Philadelphia Union begin their quest to an MLS Cup tonight. They host Cincinnati. Keep it locked here in the Fanatic for all the latest news and information. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this is 97.5 The Fanatic.
It's the Anthony Gargano Show on 97.5 The Fanatic.
Hey, Sixer fans, it's Matt Cord for the Bet Parks app, the official winning partner of your Philadelphia 76ers. The Bet Parks app is fun to use, build around on what you want right from your phone. It's easy to sign up, great customer service, and faster to win than ever before. Download the Bet Parks app today. The Bet Parks app, the official winning partner of your Philadelphia 76ers.
See website for terms and conditions. Must be 21 and in Pennsylvania or New Jersey. Gambling problem? 1-800 Gambler.
Parks Casino. This is how you win. The fun never stops at Parks Casino. Starting Thursday, October 20th with Joe Conklin's comedy. Friday, October 21st, dance the night away with the sensational Soul Cruisers. And Saturday, the music continues at 360 with Split Decision. Follow Parks on social media and check out ParksCasino.com for a complete list of upcoming entertainment. Parks Casino. This is how you win. Must be 21 or older. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Hey, this is Brian, and I'm the owner of Valley Grove Construction. We are expanding our team and hiring skilled and creative carpenters. As a company that truly values its talented carpenters, we prove it with top dollar pay, starting at $30 an hour, a healthy work-life balance, an aggressive 401k plan, a generous vacation package, paid holidays, and even a $100 weekly travel allowance. You heard me right. That's over $5,000 a year to help with gas and vehicle expenses. If you're interested in a variety of carpentry work like framing additions, setting kitchen cabinets, tiling bathrooms, basement remodeling, and historical restoration, then apply today at valleygroveconstruction.com and click the Join Our Team link. If you're tired of not working with great people, not doing the skilled work that you're capable of, or maybe you're self-employed and you're just tired of chasing down all of your suppliers for the materials that seem to never come in, then apply today at valleygroveconstruction.com. That's valleygroveconstruction.com. And click the Join Our Team link.
Here's what every Pennsylvania woman needs to know. Mehmet Oz says abortion is murder. Listen for yourself.
You know, it's still murder.
And Oz calls himself 100% pro-life.
I'm 100% pro-life.
I'm pro-life. Life starts at conception.
And if he becomes senator, Republicans could ban abortion nationwide, including here in Pennsylvania, forcing women to undergo invasive ultrasounds. Oz would let politicians ban abortion with no exceptions for rape, no exceptions for incest, no exceptions, and even jail doctors and nurses for doing their jobs. And Pennsylvania women are outraged.
He has no right to tell women what to do with their bodies.
It shouldn't be up to politicians like him.
All you need to know is that a vote for Oz is a vote to ban abortion. And you can stop him.
We can't let Oz take away our choice.
Paid for by SMP, which is responsible for the content of this ad. SenateMajority.com, not authorized by any candidate or candidates committee.
Hey, it's Jen Scordo. Tip off the NBA season with FanDuel in partnership with Valley Forge, America's number one sportsbook. Join today and get $150 in free bets guaranteed when you place your first $5 bet. Just $5. Sign up using my promo code Scordo. All customers get 3 months of NBA League Pass when they make a $5 bet on the NBA. Courtesy of FanDuel. That's pretty cool. Then you can watch all the action as you bet on everything from the money line to point spreads to totals. Best of all, you get your winnings instantly. So don't miss your chance to get $150 in free bets plus 3 months of NBA League Pass using my promo code SCORDO. Make every moment more with FanDuel, the official sportsbook partner of the NBA.
21 plus and present in PA. New customers, first online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonus issued as non-withdrawable free bets that expire in 14 days. Existing customers, $5 NBA wager required. Limit one pass per customer across both offers. Restrictions apply. Void where prohibited. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. But not with ZipRecruiter. Its powerful technology actively finds and invites qualified candidates to apply to your job. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you the needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
You could save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive, but when we just come out and say it, it feels like it falls a bit flat. So instead, we're going to have someone else say it. Because for some reason, when a random person talks about how great something is in a commercial, it's more believable.
I saved with a Progressive home and auto bundle.
And there you have it. I mean, I'm not sure why she's more believable than me, but either way, you get the point about the saving. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Discount not available in all states or situations.
Hi, I'm Adam Flager. At Flager & Associates, we've specialized in personal injury cases for more than 30 years. When you're injured, you don't need just any attorney. You need a dedicated personal injury firm. You need to concentrate on getting well again. We handle everything else. We won't rest until we get top dollar for your case and we treat you like part of our family. Not sure if you have a case? Call for a free case evaluation. 215-953-5200 or visit flagerlaw.com. That's FLAGERLAW.com.
By the time you're finished listening to this Pepsi Zero Sugar, you'll be 15 seconds closer to kickoff. Stock up now because game day is so close, you can almost taste it. Football watching. Better with Pepsi.
Listen to 97.5 The Fanatic everywhere. On Alexa at 975thefanatic.com, The Fanatic app, and now on Odyssey.
Classic. Hey, by the way, is your car bell dinging? Is your check engine light on? Oh, my. Listen, let me tell you about Meineke. I just left Meineke this morning because my car is not doing well. No, a lot of issues going on. A lot of lights. Looks like a freaking Christmas tree. But it's okay because we got Meineke. And I dropped my car off this morning at the Meineke in Glassboro, New Jersey. George took it. That's right. They're working on it as we speak. Now, listen, it could be something as simple, which I'm praying, as a loose gas cap. I don't think so. But it also could be something more serious, which I think it is. And it needs attention, right? If I want it, it's got to get attention right away. You can find out at your local Meineke. And the beauty of the local Meineke is you save $10 when you spend $50, $20. Think about it. You could save $20 when you spend $150, and you save $50 when you spend $400. All right? Bad brakes got you breaking your personal swear jar record. Give your brakes and your budget a break with 50% off brake pads and shoes at your local Meineke Car Care Center. Meineke for tires and brakes and batteries and exhaust and electrical systems and all kinds of things. You name it. Meineke doing car care right.
More of the Anthony Gargano Show now
on 97.5 The Fanatic.
All right, welcome back. Cuz Radio with the Chews, that's classic. Chews Toot says he's still singing in the penalty box.
So was I during the break. I just sang it to you. It's great. I had the Dick Allen one, by the way.
You got Dick Allen? Okay. So here we go.
Echoes of November.
Dick Allen has one. Chase Cake Dom said Joe Frazier.
We're working on that.
You got the love. How about this? Carl, my man Carl says Wilt had one back in the day by the river.
Yeah, somebody sent that to me. So Vito in the back is grabbing it right now, too.
So we got a couple good ones. So that's classic.
Everybody had a musical career after their playing career.
Oh, listen, that was all part of it, right?
Yes.
The Taste Cake Dom said he saw Joe Frazier and the Knockouts at the Latin Casino in Cherry Hill. I remember my mother used to go to the Latin Casino.
That's awesome.
They went to the Latin Casino. That's classic, man. Classic stuff.
You want to hear Dick Allen?
Yeah, let me hear
Echoes of November by Dick Allen.
I still remember Echoes of November.
Oh, that's pretty good. That's Dick Allen. That sounds like that time period.
I feel like I'm watching Goodfellas right now.
Right? I was thinking the same thing. Thank you, South Philly Sam. You probably got that on the jukebox.
And when December came, and my
guess what? That's pretty good,
though. Not bad.
Your name.
That's Dick Allen.
I knew that I was.
It does sound like Goodfellas.
You're right, right. That's great.
Karen! Stop it, Karen! I'm still going out!
That's great.
Oh, my God. That's hysterical.
We'll have more for you.
I love it. Oh, my God.
And if anybody else has suggestions,
Karen!
Please.
Oh, my God. That's great. Classic. Oh, all right. I am feeling better. Can I get, do me one more song? Get me in a Phillies mode. Give me the Ain't No Stopping Us Now Phillies song.
All right.
Right? Because that, we got to get, you got to get hype. Like, right now I'm feeling just kind of even keeled until tomorrow, because tomorrow's going to be the day. But I need a little giddy up after the NOLA.
I mean, ain't no stopping us now. They're on the move.
Huh. Ain't need an update.
No stopping them now.
We ain't losing.
There you go. Move. There you go. Bryce got the groove.
Ain't no stopping them now. They're on the move. Huh. Ain't no stopping them
That's
now.
Great.
They do. There's been so many things that's held them down. But after 30 years, Dallas Green has brought them around.
Chopper. The Chopper,
so
Judas.
Miseries, but they'll end up winning the World Series.
Yeah, man. I like it.
Kansas
I like
City
it.
Hold them back.
All right, let's get back to the phones. We go. Joe is in Allentown. Joe, you're on 97.5 Fanatic. Excuse me, Greg in South Jersey. You're on 97.5 The Fanatic. Gregory!
What's up, Cuz? How you doing today? What's up,
Joe? How you doing, buddy?
Hey, listen, I have a question that I'm sure everybody wants this answered. So, as a fan base, we're all sitting here being complacent with them going 1-1 in San Diego. Then why throw NOLA when he's demonstrated that he's a much better pitcher at home? What are your guys' thoughts?
Nah, you got to go NOLA. I don't even... You know, it's not, you got to go NOLA. I disagree with you.
Yeah,
it's not.
So.
It's
okay.
Not like he's a gas can on the road. You go with your two best pitchers.
Yeah, but I'm saying if we were content with being split, why would you throw your second best pitcher out there?
You can't play a series that way. You got to go your top two guns. That's it.
Okay. All right.
Don't overthink.
That's all I wanted to know. Thanks.
You got it. I mean, I mean, Judas. I mean, that's a conversation.
You know. No, you don't do that.
I mean, come on, man. Like, we just, I know it's been 11 years since we had the playoffs, but, you know, come on, bro.
It's not like they expected to lose yesterday.
Right. You're trying to hammer the series. Like, what do you mean?
I have an idea. Next year, opening day, don't start Wheeler or NOLA so that in games 2 and 3, your 1 and 2 are going up against their 2 and 3 to start the year. That's my idea.
Yeah, I.
What are we doing here?
I don't understand that line of thinking, man. I just
should have sat Bryce yesterday.
He gets a good rest.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, bro. Like, that's
bring back Odubel. You know, get him some reps.
I mean, come on, man. Like, I mean, I know it's been a long time since playoffs.
Now, let me ask you, so we can completely just get off that conversation, because I need that to stop. And I don't want to look too far ahead, right? We got Ranger Danger tomorrow. But game 4, what are you doing? Are you going Syndergaard again?
So Ricky said he thinks it could be Eflin.
And I heard that this morning driving in. And I said, all right, that's what I've been asking for like three weeks.
I got to tell you, I love that. I feel good about Eflin.
Go until you can.
Now that you're good late,
right,
with Sir Anthony and Alvarado, you know, because I didn't mind. Like, I weirdly trust Eflin. So, you know, I mean, there's just so much. I don't know how stretched out you get him, but between Eflin and Syndergaard, I think that's the route.
Yeah, and like the beauty is, look, the Braves with Strider, he just started. Like, he threw a couple bullpen sessions before that outing. Wheeler's at least been pitching in games, right? Like he's
right.
You know, he's been pitching in the ninth now.
Yeah.
Eflin. So we'll see. I mean, look, even if it's just 3 innings, right? You go, hey, give us the Braves. Their strategy was 3 to 4 innings, right, or 2 to 3 innings, and the third inning was when he started getting cooked. Now a lot of it had to do with that Bryson Stott at bat. But what you do is you say 2 innings with Eflin, go out for the third if he's looked okay, and just have somebody kind of loose, right? Like, you know, maybe you even go with I wouldn't be surprised. This is how I would handle it. You have Eflin going, and then you have not a falter or a Syndergaard ready, you just have one of those relievers that can warm up real quick and have them ready to go to finish out the inning if need be, and then you start getting Falter and Syndergaard ready for
the next stretch. I would go Eflin, try to get three out of Eflin.
Yeah.
And then I go Falter.
Right, but I'm saying, like, have somebody ready in case he needs to come out mid-inning.
Yeah, I hear you. But, I mean, I would then go Falter. Because here's why. Because if I go Eflin, Falter, Syndergaard, I go right, left, right.
Right, and they're setting up their lineup, obviously.
Right, so I got no problem bringing, you know, I'm hoping I can get him through three. If I can't get him through three, then I just bring Falter in whenever and let Falter go until I got to take him out.
And TJ checks in. He says, it's going to be Thor game four. You have to start him with his performance versus Atlanta. It's not like he was lights out against Atlanta. He just, you know, he did his job.
He was good. I mean, three innings, gave up a couple.
Yeah, I'm cool with what Syndergaard did, but it's not like, let's not say that Syndergaard was
right
lights out that you go, oh, you have to start him.
Conversation again. Oh, God. I mean, he gave you three solid with giving up two runs. It's still an ERA of 6/9.
Right.
All right. So, yeah, I think you got to go Eflin, Falter, then Syndergaard and see what you got Saturday. You might need one today or tomorrow. You hope not, but, you know, I don't know. I mean, if Rangers pitch count, you got to make sure he's all right.
Yeah, I mean, look, as long as he's not – I'm chalking it up to nerves, that Braves. It's not like the Braves weren't even really hitting him. He was walking, guys. That was on his own. So,
which is something that was odd.
But,
he averted disaster a couple of times.
Yeah, he did. He did that double play in the first inning, you know. Padres, the favorite tomorrow right now, -112, but Phil's still minus money, 104.
For the series?
No, for tomorrow.
You said the Padres are the favorite? What'd you say?
For tomorrow's game.
Okay. All right.
Series odds, it's split, -110.
So it's a pick your nose.
Yep.
All right. Let's go to Seth. You're on 97.5 The Fanatic. Seth.
Yo, Ant, what's going on?
What's up, Seth? How are you, buddy?
Pretty good. Well, I'm just going to the Sixers game tonight with my dad. Super pumped.
Nice. What are you thinking, man? What are you thinking?
I think we got a chance. I like that -4 line. I think Embiid's going to have a huge game. I agree. I think he was a little mopey the other night. I don't get it.
Did you study? I didn't study. I was in Philly's mode, so I didn't really study it, and I fell asleep afterwards. I wanted to watch it and kind of study it. I don't know. I mean, you tell me what you saw.
Yeah, I mean, it was surprising, right? Because I thought he kind of turned a corner, you know, had the kid, everything like that, got married, whatever. And, you know, I thought he was a little bit more mature. It was a little bit like a couple years ago. But, you know, we had the Phillies on one TV, Sixers on another, computer with the Flyers. So we were taking a little peek at everything. But so I wasn't studying it, but hopefully it turns a corner. We get the energy in the building tonight.
So I heard more Doc talk than Embiid talk.
Well, I think the Doc talk is more, you know, what's up with the bench. We thought we were, you know, deep and everything like that. They outscored us by, I don't know how much, but a lot, it seemed like. So, I mean, he definitely, you know, if they don't turn it around, this, you know, they might be pulling a Rob Thompson move, going a little interim head coach in the middle of the year into the playoffs.
It's so early. Like, I always hate the overreact. It's one game, right? I know. Here's the thing. It was Boston, so it's Boston, and there's a lot riding on this season. Like, I feel the same way. Like, I feel, when it comes to the Sixers, like, I feel a pressure. Like, I don't know if you do, too. Like, I expect them. Like, they got to get to the finals, man.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I'm there. I mean, even not getting to the Eastern Conference Finals, right? Like, everyone's like, yeah, you got to get there. They, you know, there's a lot of good.
I think you're past that now. I think,
yeah, no, I'm with you, especially Harden, you know, coming back and healthy.
Yeah.
Got some other pieces, and I love.
And Harden looks great. Oh, he looked great the other night, you know.
Yeah, and he looked great, right? And Tucker, you know, he won't, you know, if you're not watching the game, you look at those stats, you're going to say, what the hell is he doing? But, you know, but he hustles, man. He's definitely an intangible guy and going to be big for the locker room. And hopefully maybe they'll kick Joel, you know, to get him to, you know, be a little more focused and not moping around. But I'm super pumped. I think Joe's going to have a big game tonight. Turn it around and the fans there.
I'm a Joe fan unabashedly. I am. I hear you, everybody. When they come, and thanks, my brother. Enjoy the game tonight, Seth. I'm an unabashed Joe fan, man. I get it. I agree with you guys when we talk about turnovers and, you know, he had six turnovers the other night. I don't know, Tunis. He's a great player. I still believe you can win with him. I know there's that school of thought about not being able to win with him or a big or whatever how you want to say it.
But look at how the team's built. Like, you have Tyrese Maxey and James Harden, and I haven't seen Joel Embiid ever being the type of guy who was like, you know, I need to get mine. I haven't seen that yet. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think he's going to be like, no, like, look, he's going to demand the ball. He should. He's Joel Embiid. He's
right.
MVP candidate every single year. But I don't think when some nights where you're going to need Maxey or Harden to step up, he's going to have complaints about it.
Right.
He'll probably be upset if they lose. And he said, yeah, I should have had the ball more. That's any athlete. That's any competitor. Right.
I got a buddy of mine. I always joke around. I call him Pop, right? South Philly's Pop. And he's a great basketball dude. And he said, the problem, I got to pull it up here. Because I hate starting Joe, Toby, and Tucker. And I agree with that. That does feel slow, like a slow front court, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the problem with that front court is the pace does kill Maxey. He's right about that.
Yeah, he loves flying.
Right? It does. So starting the fourth quarter, you got Toby and Tucker on the bench. Maxey scores that quick nine. I saw that, right? Because we're watching the Phillies, but I'm watching to keep one eye. And I saw Maxey go off because he was so quiet. And then he doesn't touch the ball again. Like, he's got to give him more, got to give him more touches. And I think you got to start it differently, and you got to focus and put the ball in Maxey's hands because he's the creator, right? Like, he can create his own shot. There's so much stuff he can do offensively, and he's got speed.
So what, you go Tucker to the bench, I would imagine.
Yeah.
And then what, is Melton one of your wing starters?
Yeah, I would go that route more than – I don't like Tucker in the start. I do think that's too slow. Joe, Tobias, and Tucker, that's slow. It's slow front court. And I agree with him. I think my boy South Philly Pop, I think he's right. I think it hurts. It really hurts Maxey.
Speaking of the front court, would you like to hear By the River by Will Chamberlain?
Yeah.
By the river, neath the shady.
By the river, neath the shady tree, just my baby. Just my baby and me, we
barely
kiss, cuddle close. By the river, neath the shady tree.
This is another good song, too.
By the river, neath the shady tree.
Like Sam Cooke.
Keeps us company, we sing, cling, and everything. By the river, neath the shady tree.
This is
Sunday, in the bright
sunshine. With the stilt, man.
Chicken in the basket.
That's classic.
That's what it says on the record, too. With the stilt.
Does it really?
Yeah.
They hold on tight, strolling back to town by the river. Neath the shady.
That's classic.
That's great.
That is classic. Look at that. Wait, there hasn't been more hockey players? Singers?
I could try to find out.
Or football players? Like, I'm trying to remember. There's got to be more. Like, back in the day, those dudes. Yeah, Will Dick Allen, man, were strong. Classic. 610-632-0975. Hey, a couple things. One, Mikey Garofolo, NFL Network, is going to join us at 12:30. We got the Geek is at 1, so we'll do that. A couple other things. I do want to talk some Sixers as well. It's the home opener tonight, man. Do you feel that little, like, pressure? Like, I feel like I need them to come together this year.
Yeah. Yeah. You know? I don't know if like, I feel that tonight, like, but, you know, like, you know yeah, it has to be this year.
I'm talking about long term, like, you know, like, I need them. Like, I need you, fellas.
Yeah, this can't be, like, a dream team situation.
Nah,
you know, like, what I'm
saying? I need a run, like, yeah. A big-time run.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right, 610-632-0975. Let's talk about the Bet Parks app for a second. It's a Bet Parks Thursday, and the beauty of the Bet Parks Thursday is now the NBA is back, and the NBA same-game parlays are a blast, right? They're a blast. The SGPs, because you look at it tonight, and you go, all right, well, I like Harden over. I like him. Now, you know, Embiid tonight's going to score. You got to go Embiid rebounds. He looks like he's focused on the boards. You know, does Maxey get more involved tonight? Maxey over threes. So I think Harden more dimes tonight. I think more assists. So I would look at that. And you build it. And you can build it. You know, you can throw one to Giannis or whatever you want to do. It's the best, man. It's the Bet Parks same game parlays for the NBA. But they got them for football. And they got all the props. And they have, you name it, like Thursday Night Football tonight. You got Saints in Arizona. Slop. But it's more fun when you got Bet Parks on the game, right? Like, so check it out. Bet Parks. We heard from Jimmy Rollins, who's a Bet Parks spokesman and content creator. A lot of fun. You're going to love it. The Bet Parks app has you covered for baseball, basketball, football, hockey. It's right there on the Bet Parks app. Go to betparks.com, download it. New customers can get up to $750 in bonus play if your first bet is not a winner. The website's got all the details. You got to be in Pennsylvania or New Jersey. You got to be 21. Gambling problem, call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Fanatic Sports Update.
Series tied at 1. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this update is brought to you by Temple Football. Hey, Philly, don't miss an AAC showdown. Under the lights when Temple Football battles Tulsa this Friday at 7:30 at Lincoln Financial Field. Kids tickets on game night are only $10. Visit AliceTix.com. The Phillies lost to the Padres yesterday after having a 4-0 lead. Fell apart. Aaron Nola and Brad Hand did not pitch well after that. 7-5, the Phillies lose. Series tied at 1. Coming back to Philadelphia, though. Game 3 is tomorrow. Ranger Suarez will get the start for the Phillies. He'll go up against Joe Musgrove. Games 4 and 5 also at Citizens Bank Park. Sixers back in action tonight. They're a home opener for the 2022 season. They host the Milwaukee Bucks. Tip-off will be at 7:30. You can listen live right here on The Fanatic. And, of course, the Philadelphia Union, 8 o'clock. They kick things off against Cincinnati, the quest for the MLS Cup for the Union. This update is also brought to you by KinConnector.org, raising your grandchildren or another loved one's children. Pennsylvania's KinConnector connects kinship families to services and resources. Visit KinConnector.org, paid for with Pennsylvania taxpayer dollars. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this is 97.5 The Fanatic.
Anthony Gargano, weekdays 10 to 2 on 97.5 The Fanatic.
In the Delaware Valley, helping each other isn't just the neighborly thing to do. It's in our blood. It's in our plasma, too. In fact, over the years, thousands of Philadelphia area residents have helped people they'll never even meet by donating plasma at local CSL plasma donation centers. Your plasma donations have been instrumental in our efforts to create new therapies for patients living with rare and serious diseases and have helped us provide medicines and vaccines to people in more than 100 countries around the world. We're proud to be part of this community, and we can't wait to say thank you in person at local events in the community throughout the fall. So please, when you see the CSL tent, stop by to say hi, hydrate, and grab a fun giveaway. Interested in other ways you can partner with CSL to improve patients' quality of life? Ask us about participating in one of our clinical trials or learn more at CSLBearingTrials.com. That's CSLBearingTrials.com. We thank you for all that you do, Philadelphia, because together we are saving lives.
We marvel at the young pitcher who can throw a fastball 100 miles per hour. Unfortunately, over time, the fastball slows down. The successful pitchers make adjustments and continue to win. The pitchers who don't retire early. Don't let ED symptoms force you to retire. At Forge Medical Group, our board-certified medical director and team of physicians treat ED with acoustic wave therapy, which uses sound waves to increase circulation, repair existing blood vessels, and even form new ones. It's safe, simple, and non-invasive, with no drugs, no surgery, no injections, and no side effects. Get your confidence back with revolutionary new acoustic wave therapy from Forge Medical Group. Appointments fill up fast, so call Forge Medical Group now at 610-632-8181. That's 610-632-8181. Or visit ForgeMedicalGroup.com. Get back in the game. 610-632-8181.
Every drive starts somewhere. For First Trust Bank, our drive started in Philadelphia and continues to this day. As Philly's hometown bank for more than 85 years, we know this city's people. We understand their passions, and we work our tails off to help them reach their goals every day. Because Philadelphia dreams deserve a Philadelphia bank. First Trust Bank, the official bank of the Philadelphia Eagles. Member FDIC.
Visit Barlow Chevrolet this fall and receive discounts below MSRP on select vehicles in stock. Competitive financing rates are also available to well-qualified buyers through GM Financial. New vehicles like Equinox, Silverado, and Malibu are arriving daily, so now is the time to reserve yours. At Barlow, we will always order the vehicle you want with no additional dealer fees or markups. It's our goal to keep the buying process simple, convenient, and hassle-free. This fall, find new roads at Barlow Chevrolet in Delran or at barlowchevrolet.com.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. 40% of Americans don't have $400 saved in case of an emergency. People are working harder and harder, but falling further and further behind. That's why at our firm, our fee is free. You don't pay us anything unless we win your case. When you're injured in an accident or hurt on the job, choosing a lawyer will be the most important decision you'll have to make. Injured? Call Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
If you're wondering if your furnace is going to last through the winter, don't chance it. It's John Kincaid for H&H Heating and Air Conditioning. Trust H&H for a thorough system checkup before winter. We had ours last week, and with H&H's $59 gas furnace tune-up, including the carbon monoxide safety check, you're going to have peace of mind before the cold. If you need a new system, H&H has rebates of up to $1,500 or 0% financing for 18 months for qualified buyers. Visit DelcoHVAC.com to schedule your $59 tune-up or new system estimate today. That's DelcoHVAC.com.
Finding the right Medicare plan? Oof, no easy feat. Kind of like those dances my granddaughter loves making me do. But then I found Walgreens FindRx coverage. Lets you compare plans online, over the phone, or in person. Made Medicare shopping so easy. Plus, I found plans with low-cost copays. I can get down with that. Medicare annual enrollment ends December 7th. Find a plan that's right for you at walgreens.com/Medicare.
Progressive is America's number one motorcycle insurer, so we understand motorcycles. No, really, we have a bike translator.
Okay, so this bike feels like he's capable of a little more than just trips to the convenience store.
Oh, also, he wants to let you know that you can buy a gallon of ice cream instead of a pint every time. Those are his words. So he said roughly like, blink the last wheel. It doesn't really translate, but the way he said it was super funny.
Get 24/7 roadside assistance with Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates. Roadside assistance subject to policy terms and limits and may require comprehensive coverage.
No House Advantage is changing the game with the most dynamic fantasy sports platform available. You can play in pick'em contests versus other people, and you get the shot at winning $250,000 plus in cash. It's so easy. You enter a contest by selecting your player props. You can pick players at will, anybody. So if you know the players, you've got the advantage. You can climb the leaderboard and win big money every day. Sign up now with promo code Fanatic at NoHouseAdvantage.com or download the app using promo code Fanatic to get a first deposit matchup up to $25. It's absolutely awesome. No House Advantage is only available in select U.S. states. Users must be 18 years of age or older to play. See terms of use for additional details at nohouseadvantage.com.
Hey, we all love the fall, don't we? Cooler temperature, October baseball, football, kids back in school playing sports. It's also the best time to get your home in shape. So, what do? Call my man.
Anthony!
Yes, Anthony. That's right. Anthony LaBruciano of LaBruciano Roofing and Exteriors. Anthony will fix whatever's ailing your home on the outside. That's right. Anthony LaBruciano and the experts at LaBruciano Roofing and Exteriors, recently named Contractor of the Year in the entire Mid-Atlantic by CertainTeed. Now, look, if your roof is looking tired, maybe has a small leak, maybe your windows are drafty, your siding's old, it's cracked, showing signs of mold, don't worry and fret. Now, just call my man, Anthony LaBruciano. I tell you all the time, he's the shingle master, and you're going to have an expert who's proud of every single job, especially yours. He's got a huge warehouse, all right? Right there with everything with your home's exteriors that you need. Trust Anthony. Hundreds of five-star Google reviews. Contractor of the Year. Because Anthony LaBruciano Roofing Exteriors will fix your home right the first time. On time and on budget. Call him. 610-265-ROOF. 610-265-ROOF. Or go to paroofpros.com. That's paroofpros.com.
WPEN Burlington, Philadelphia. A Beasley Media Group station. Home of the most entertaining sports talk in Philadelphia. 97.5. The Fanatic. Philadelphia. Win $1,000 right now. 97.5 The Fanatic is bleeding green.
Yes, we are bleeding green and red. And now's your chance to win $1,000. Text the word studio. That's right, studio, S-T-U-D-I-O, to 45911. Text the word studio to 45911, or you can enter it on the Fanatic app or at 975fanatic.com. That's the word studio. One winner selected at random is going to win $1,000 in this company-wide contest. Winners will get a call from Beasley, so be sure to answer your phone. Complete rules at 975thefanatic.com. 975 The Fanatic's Bleeding Green is presented by the Bet Park Sportsbook Casino app. Everything you want in a digital casino and sportsbook. Please never text and drive. Good luck.
Good luck.
Good luck. Good luck. 12 o'clock across the Delaware Valley. Noontime. It's amazing, man. The perfect confluence. We got a Phillies weekend ahead of us, and the 6-0 Eagles are on the bye. That I can't get enough of. We got the Sixers tonight against the Bucks. We got a Flyers team. Guess what? They put up some fight last night.
Yes, they did.
Early back-to-back against Florida after the comeback win against Tampa. And they put up fight against them, Junis.
Yeah, look, man, I think
it's the torch.
The vibes right now. I mean, the fact that the Eagles are on a bye, that it's almost like suspicious. You know what I mean? It's suspicious. You put all your energy into the Phils this weekend. That's a good thing.
And don't forget,
worked out
Sunday,
well.
The Junis and I, so you and I are going to be live at Xfinity Live.
Yes.
On Sunday morning, 11 o'clock to 2:30. Getting you set for game 5.
Yeah, I can't wait,
man. We're doing a baseball pregame show, an NLCS pregame on an October Sunday,
yeah,
dude.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful. By the way, let me also point this out, and we talked about this yesterday. It's suspicious that the Phillies are playing the weekend NLCS when the Birds are on a bye. It's also a little suspicious. We always talk about the world and the atmosphere telling us things. Phil Stroh's game 6 if necessary in Houston. The Eagles play the Texans in Houston that week.
Wow, can you imagine?
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Can you imagine?
The world works in mysterious ways, Ant.
Philly Stroh's? What? Dude, Stroh's are nasty, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. That's all right.
They're beating the Yankees. How about Verlander last night?
Yeah, man, he's just nasty.
Dude, are you serious with that? So, in case people miss the game, he winds up giving it a home run to Bader from the Yankees.
Who's gotten now four in the playoff.
Right?
He's part of the Montgomery trade, right?
Pretty yes. sure. So he gives up a home run to Bader. It's there's an early 1-0 in the second. And that's it. That's it. Look at this line, dude. 103 pitches, 6 innings, 3 hits, just that one home run, 1 walk, and 11 strikeouts. 11 strikeouts.
Yeah, he's nasty. He's going to be doing that when he's 50.
Did you see who came in, though? Gave him a big 7th inning?
Hector!
Yes, Hector! Gave him a perfect 7th. Wow. I would love to see Hector.
He had a nice year.
Wouldn't that be nice to see Hector in the playoffs, in the World Series?
Sit fastball, lay off the split.
Right? That's it.
That's it. Look, he had a much better year this year. He was dominant to start the season. ERA crept up to close to 4. I like him. He's fiery. He's one of those guys. He's like Alvarado, but a righty, right? He'll take the ball every day.
But he don't have the gusto.
But that's
of
the
Alvarado.
Thing. Like, I never understood. Make Hector the closer. I know Mariano had one pitch. It was nasty, right? My man's got.
It was also hard.
Like fastball splitter, and the splitter. If the pitch is at the knees, lay off, because it might be fastball at the knees. Yeah, or it's going to fall off the table. It's a splitter. Like the book is kind of easy on Neris.
Well, and the other thing with him is, it's not like he blows your way with his fastball.
No.
Speaking of which, oof, that hater.
Yeah. Yeah, he looked
I good. Was watching, I just like watching his delivery. I mean, his arm action. You see his arm action?
Yeah, he must have worked on some things because he looked like he was in trouble.
He did.
Like, he looked like he may have been on the tail end of a fiery career. Remember the Phillies beat him up? It was the Vierling Bohm home runs. Yeah. And then even when he first went to San Diego, he wasn't good. And now he's been locked in for a while now.
Yeah, he looks actually really good, too. He looks really good.
They got some good options out of the pen. The dude before him, the righty, who gave him 2 innings yesterday.
So he's only 28.
Yeah.
Hater.
He threw a lot of innings, though, in his Milwaukee career, which is why I was thinking maybe
right.
is that it? Because they used him as a 2-3 inning guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, he comes in throwing fire. Just, right. You know.
I mean, there was a time he was unhittable. Well, even this year, remember the home run they hit? What? That was his first home run allowed in 18 months? Like something ridiculous.
Yeah, that was wild.
And it was Vierling and Bohm. Bohm, who wasn't really hitting with power yet, and Vierling, who didn't hit with power, Mr. Carshield. Two of them go hit home runs against him.
Yeah. Well, listen, tomorrow we need, you said Ranger Danger, and I need the bats against Musgrove. The good thing is Bryce looks good. Bryce is hot.
Yes.
If you look at it, I mean, we just need, you know what you mean? You need Schwarber to get a little hot, like even more. Hit the mammoth home run. You got to get him rolling. I want the lefties against Musgrove. I know those two have a lot of strikeouts against him, but you gotta get right. You know what the shame is? I just go back to you. Just forgive me, Junis, because I still need to get that game out of my craw.
Yeah.
But
that's fine. Work out any way you need.
2-4-0.
Yeah, it sucks.
Like, as that's going on, I don't know about you. I was texting you. I know about you. And they're just, oh my God, hit after hit. Now, they were bleeders, but who cares? Like, it was incredible. And it's 4-0. Aren't you thinking that? I mean, that was the world dance, the World Series dance.
Yeah, no, I know. And it sucks. It sucks that that happened, the 4-run lead. And look, I remember texting you that when they got Machado, I was like, all right, it's a huge out because it's still tied at 4. Right. And you go, all right, 4-4.
Right.
You can get out of it. But then he doesn't get out of the inning. Then the next couple guys get some base hits to make it 7-4. And if they got out of that inning, you're still going, all right, that sucks that they gave up the 4-run lead, but at least it's tied. Once it goes up 7-4, you go, oh, man, that's a tough spot. I'll be right back. I'm going to try to Keith Pompey may join us.
Cool. Yeah, but the one thing that you looked at was I just needed you to, you know, You're up 4-0. Like, it reminded the two home runs. And I wonder, we talked about this, whether or not he sat too long, because you had that long inning where you scored four runs, and sometimes a guy sits too long. And it felt like that inning, he sat too long. And then what happens is, what, he gave up the two bombs. Remember, consecutive pitches. The one was that line drive, Drury, boom. And then the other one was the Bell bomb. But sometimes when you sit like that, he gave up some hard-hit balls that inning. And that's a product of sitting, you know? Anyway, all right, let's switch gears a little bit because I do want to talk some Sixers Bucks tonight. And joining us on the Comcast Business Hotline, I miss him. He does such a great job covering the Sixers for the Inquirer, Inquirer.com, Keith Pompey. Keith!
What's up? How you doing, brother? You doing well?
What's up, baby?
Well, I'm good.
You good, man? You feeling all right? I love miss you, buddy.
Yeah, I miss you, too. I still got to get that autograph, though.
I'll get you Adam Sandler's autograph. Don't worry about it. He's coming into town soon.
Yeah, I've been all right. But look, I'm going to tell you, this is funny. I was talking to a reporter who was like, yeah, I had like a cameo in the movie. And I'm like, yeah, dude, that's done. My man was in the real movie. Not like, you know, your C-level movie or B-level movie the dude was bragging about. So I was bragging on you. And he like kind of got upset, but it's all good.
I love you, brother. I love you, man. That's why you let your friends do it. You know what I'm saying? So what? I want to ask you a question because I don't know if I like Tucker in the starting lineup because it feels like a slow front court with Joe, Tobias, and Tucker.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think that's one of those things. I think we got to give it a little bit of time. We got to do that. I mean, and it's easy to say, like, okay, we can get someone else. But the thing that Tucker brings, like, when you look at it, you know, Tucker is in there to, like, free up stuff for Joel and also James, like, in regards to the screens. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got the big four, and then you have him. So it's one of those things where I think we got to give it time. Another thing that I think a lot of people aren't talking about is he did have knee surgery, right? And so he wasn't able to like do a lot of stuff. Not saying he was hampered, but you know, I think when you're coming off of that conditioning, all that other stuff, it takes you a while to ramp it up. So to me, it didn't look good the first night, of course. But I think that's one of those things where we got to give it a little bit of time to see what he can really do. And then if not, then maybe they may have to make some adjustments. But I think it's hard to just base it off of.
Oh, yeah. Football. Listen, I'm not going to overreact. It's one game, right? Like, so, you know, whatever. Yeah. I'm just talking about in general, just from the athletic standpoint. You know what I mean? Because it does feel a little slow. I agree with you. I think Tucker's going to play a big role. I'm just trying to figure out, you know, is Melton better in that lineup because you have a little more athletic? But it's an interesting kind of thing. The only thing I think they need to do is you got to look at, you have to have the ball in Maxie's hands a little bit more. Like, use Maxie a little bit, only because he's your most dynamic player. And remember at the beginning, and I'm just trying to extrapolate, right? I'm just throwing them out there to see what you think. But like the early part of the fourth quarter, when he goes off for nine straight, like I think you need to have moments like that where he has the ball.
Yeah, I agree with you. And you know what? And it's funny because I always say that term like when it's not funny. Like I need to stop saying that, but it's just a go-to, I guess. But see, you raised up two great points. You know, I think like you look at, you talked about Melton, you also talk about Maxie. And I think that with the way this roster is constructed, like with Harden, like he's a guy that needs the ball. Maxie's a guy that needs the ball. What you would say is in the perfect situation is, okay, one of these guys come off the bench and then they just go straight get buckets. But with the success that Maxey had, like, coming off the bench would kind of sort of, like, be viewed as a demotion.
Right.
But at the same time, you're looking at it, and people are saying, yo, give Maxey the ball, give Maxey the ball, give Maxey the ball. So I understand, you know, what you're saying. It's like one of those things right now, you know, in order for the Sixers to be successful, and believe me, James had 35 points. But you look at Maxey and you're saying to yourself, for them to be successful, we want him to be the guy that's second on the team in scoring or something like that, right? And then just to go back to Melton a little bit, another thing about this roster is like, yes, he's a solid 3-and-D. He can do certain things. But unfortunately, this team doesn't have a lot of ball handling. Mm-hmm. And if you start all three of those guys, then you're saying, well, what are we going to do when we start staggering lineups and we start bringing in a backup one? So, that's one of the weaknesses of the 76ers roster right now.
Yeah, that's a great point. Talking to Keith Pompey, Inquirer.com. It's funny. I was talking to Daryl, and I go, what do you think your backup one is? I mean, obviously, you know, Maxey's going to be your secondary guy, but who's your true backup one? He's like, you know, I don't know. I don't know if you have one. And he goes, we'll find out. And he's right, which is like, that's the one area, you know, again, in the playoffs, it doesn't really come to play that much. But during a long regular season, just to give up, like just to take minutes away from guys, like just so, like Harden, you got to go easy with Harden. They know that. Like they don't want to burn Harden. So you, at some point, I think you need to get somebody that can handle a ball a little bit.
Yes, exactly. I mean, you know, and it's one of those things, like you look at it, they don't have a pure point guard or pure guy like that. Question. The thing about Melton, like, you don't want to burn Harden out. The thing about Melton, a lot of people don't know this, he was a power forward in high school. He was just a guy who could jump out the gym and extremely athletic. So, you know, he's not ideally the guy that you want handling the ball. You know what I mean? He's like a 3-and-D type of wing who's a great athlete. But, yeah, you're right. I mean, you look at that, they only have 14 guys on the roster. You know, there are two things, weaknesses that they have. One is a secondary, well, Maxey is a secondary, but I'm talking about a backup ball handler.
Right. He's more of a scorer anyway, so we know that.
More of a scorer. Yeah. They need a backup ball handler, somebody who can get everybody the ball.
You need like TJ. You know,
yeah,
sounds crazy, but you need a guy like that.
Yeah, a guy like that. And the funny thing is, the TJ thing, we kind of, when he was there, people were like, oh man, he's a dime a dozen, right?
Yeah.
And now you look at how he used to feed the post to Embiid and get Embiid the ball in the right spot. So now you're like, wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Like, you know, they haven't had anybody like that since.
Yeah, and he was valuable in that sense where he just, you know, he worked so hard. Like, he knew where to go. He always could trust him to make the right pass. And that's kind of the only thing. Now, let me ask you, big picture, you know, what do you think they're trying to do? Like, what do you accomplish? And where do you think, how it works, how does it work with Joel? Like, you know, I know at times, I mean, people, we talk about the 6 turnovers and, you know, we're always going to over-examine his game. But how do you think the offense flows? Like, what do you think their whole aim is going to be?
You know, that's a great question, man. I think they gotta meet each other in the middle somewhere. You know, I think, and the reason why I'm saying that is because, you know, now Joel's playing with a guy who has the ball in his hand.
Uh-huh.
You know, he dribbles a lot, and some of the spots that Joel likes are some of the spots that he likes. So
right.
I think they have to, you know, they have to agree to, like, basically, you know, come together and work something out. But the one thing that, the thing about Joel that a lot of people don't talk about is, you know, Joel, just because he's 7'2", 280, he's not a traditional center. I mean, you know, and we get mad at him. People get mad at him when he missed shots and when he doesn't, you know, do what we think 7'2", 280 people do. But then when he's successful, the same people are like, wow, look how athletic that guy is. You know, he's great. But right now, it's kind of like they need to find a common denominator where Joel does do more post-ups at times, right?
Yes.
You know, with rolls, instead of like running a couple a little bit and then popping, you know, sometimes he has to get more hard rolls to the basket and then oppose his will on people. But again, it's hard to change somebody in their like seventh playing season where they were doing the stuff that they normally do. They became a perennial all-star and a two-time MVP runner-up. You understand? It's like,
that's
who he is.
Yeah, I think that's brilliant. I think you're right on. I think meeting in the middle is kind of where they need to be, where at times he can be face to basket, but at times he's got to go down the block a little bit. I mean, it's amazing because we know what kind of incredible skill he has, but at some point you still want a little more of that traditional big man dominance because you know he could do that too.
Yeah, and you know, and the crazy part about it is if you look at the stats and the analytics to all this stuff, like Joel, like 2 years ago, and he was leading the NBA in post-ups. And mm-hmm. But at the same time, we're saying to ourselves, what are you talking about? I'm seeing the guy shooting threes. So that tells you how the game has changed.
Yeah.
I mean, this guy that we're saying he shoots the ball too much outside, but he's actually leading the league in post-ups. So it's just a different game nowadays. But, again, there aren't a lot of dominant big guys like him. So, you know, he's a mismatch on the block. It's just a matter of, you know, like you said, meeting in the middle. But, again, we complain, but at the same time, he leads the league in post-ups, which is crazy.
Yeah. Listen, I'm an unabashed Joe fan. Like, when I love the guy's game and what he does, the whole thing, it's just got to kind of mesh together. But it's game one. I like tonight. I like to see come back. You know how it is. Like, you start with Boston, mm-hmm. lose to the Celtics. You know, I mean, that's Philadelphia, right? Like, you know, I actually thought they were going to blow this. I thought they were going to win the game. So I was greedy, you know.
Yeah, you were greedy.
I was greedy. Yeah. I'll settle for the Phillies tomorrow. I'll settle for beat the Bucks tonight. And the Phillies come back and win the bar. You know what I'm saying, brother?
Yeah, that'll be a great weekend, or start of a weekend, right?
I like it. Great stuff, man. Always a pleasure, Keith. We love you, buddy.
Hey, thanks for having me on, brother. Thank you.
Always a pleasure, man. You're the best. Keith Pompey, Inquirer.com on the Comcast Business Hotline. All right, we'll come back. We got a lot of stuff that we're doing. Because we're going to get Mike Garofolo every Thursday. He checks in. We got to ask him, Chunas, about how ugly the game is.
Whew, yeah.
I mean, right? So we got to talk a little bit about that. And we got the Geek coming up at 1. That's all straight ahead. Cuz Radio Chunas, 97.5 The Fanatic. Let's talk about the Bet Parks app, shall we? Because I tell you about it all the time. It's a Thursday. It's a Bet Parks Thursday. And we got same game parlay Sixers Bucks tonight. So Embiid, I think, over rebounds. Because you can see him, you know, crashing boards. He said he wants to focus on defense and rebounding too. He told us. So I like that. I like Harden over the assists. I think Maxey over the points at home. I could see that. So build your same game parlay on the Bet Parks Sportsbook app. It's unbelievable, the Bet Parks app. So it's, you know, sports and casino games all wrapped up into one right in your pocket. But, of course, we love the sports. So you have NFL, Thursday Night Football tonight. We'll talk about that. You got college weekend. Of course, you got the Yankees Stros. And then it's a Phillies Red October in Philadelphia. College and NFL as well. All right there on the Bet Parks app. It's loads of fun. Go to betparks.com for all the details. In fact, new customers right now, you get $750 in sportsbook bonus if your first bet is not a winner. So check out all the details. You got to be in Pennsylvania or New Jersey. You got to be 21. Gambling problem, call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Fanatic Sports Update.
Series title one. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this update is brought to you by the Valley Forge Tourism and Convention Board. Sip and explore your way through Montgomery County. Visit MoncoMakersPassport.com for your free passport. That'll take you to the best breweries, wineries, and distilleries in the area, plus earn prizes along the way. That's MoncoMakersPassport.com. The Phillies are now tied, one win apiece with the San Diego Padres after losing yesterday, blowing a 4-0 lead. Yeah, it hurt. Padres came all the way back. They won 7-5. Now game three is tomorrow in Citizens Bank Park. So the next three games in South Philadelphia. Ranger Suarez gets the start. He goes up against Joe Musgrove. The Sixers back in action tonight. They lost game one of the 2022 season in Boston. Tonight's their home opener. They host the Milwaukee Bucks. Game tips off at 7:30. You can listen live right here in the Fanatic. You just heard from Keith Pompey to talk about the Sixers. That will be podcasted on 97.5thefanatic.com. Coming up next, Mike Garofalo joins the show to talk some Eagles and NFL. The Geek answers your fantasy football questions at 1. This update is also brought to you by MedExpress. You think ER bills care how much money is in your bank account? No, they're just paper. They can't care, but MedExpress can. They offer affordable care all on your schedule. MedExpress open 8 to 8 every day. No appointment necessary. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this is 97.5 The Fanatic.
It's the Cuz, Anthony Gargano, weekdays 10 to 2 on 97.5 The Fanatic.
This is Brad Musburger's VSiN Action Update on 97.5 The Fanatic. Brought to you by DraftKings Sportsbook. Use the promo code FANATIC when using the DraftKings app.
A 5-run fifth inning, the difference as the San Diego Padres beat Philadelphia 8-5 to take game two of the NLCS to even up the series at one game each. Game three coming up at Citizens Bank Park on Friday. Ranger Suarez for the Phillies, 10-7, 3.65 ERA in the regular season. Philadelphia minus 102 of the money line. The Padres counter with Joe Musgrove. He's minus 108 of the money line, 7.5 over the total on Friday at Citizens Bank Park. 76ers at home tonight against Milwaukee. 76ers laying 4 with a total of 225 at Wells Fargo Center. 50% off site-wide at OmahaSteaks.com. Enter the promo code VSIN at checkout. Receive an additional $30 off. Mike Sennett, 97.5, The Fanatic.
Fall is upon us, so it's that time of year again to consider replacing your old, drafty windows and doors before another cold winter season rolls in. Hi, it's Ricky Bowe, and when I need a company to help me with these home projects, I turn to the experts, my good friends at Guida Door and Window. Act now and receive 20% off all windows and doors. Plus, Guida will allow you to start your project today with no money out of pocket and take up to 3 years to pay it off, interest-free, once the job is expertly installed. So, you'll be able to start enjoying all the benefits of new, highly energy-efficient windows and doors, including an increased comfort level of your home and lowered monthly energy bills, while taking advantage of 20% savings and having the luxury of paying off your project with 0% interest-free for up to 36 months. But you must act now. This offer is for a limited time only. Restrictions apply. For full details, call Guida today to schedule a free, no-obligation in-home estimate at 1-877-GO-GUIDA or visit them at GoGuida.com. That's GoGuida.com.
Hey everyone, it's Connor Thomas, and as a proud graduate of the Connecticut School of Broadcasting, now the CSB Media Arts Center, I have to tell you about all of the great things I learned at their Cherry Hill, New Jersey campus to get me to where I am today. I went from a cold calling sales job to being on air at the Fanatic discussing Philly sports for a living, and I owe a huge thanks to the CSB Media Arts Center for helping me get here. I did their 8-week day program over in Jersey at their Cherry Hill campus, and before I knew it, their job placement connection set me up for my first day here at 97.5. That's because their instructors let you get hands-on experience from the first day you walk in the door. Audio and video editing, TV and sports broadcasting, and on-air performance are all career fields that are possible for you, and you don't need to go to a four-year school to get there. Just visit GoCSB.com to set up a studio tour and see for yourself. Content creation is huge in the world today, and the best way to set yourself apart is through the awesome experience you can get from my friends over at CSB Media Arts Center. They're even VA approved. Just visit GoCSB.com and you can have your life changed just like they changed mine.
Hey, it's Jen Scordo. Start NFL Week 7 off with a no-sweat same-game parlay from FanDuel in partnership with Valley Forge. Whether you're new to FanDuel or not, get free bets back if your Thursday night same-game parlay doesn't hit. Same-game parlays combine bets for a chance at a bigger payout. The Saints travel to Arizona for Thursday night football. Let's build a same-game parlay, shall we? Arizona's going to win, take the money line, and then add some player props. Alvin Kamara with an over on the rushing yards, and a James Conner anytime TD. I like it. You can build your own or choose from one of the popular pre-built SGPs. However you want to play, bet the NFL on Thursday night with a no-sweat same-game parlay. Sign up using my promo code SCORDO, so whether you're new to FanDuel or a current user, you're all set. Just download the app with promo code SCORDO and make every moment more with FanDuel, an official sports betting partner of the NFL.
21 plus and present in PA. 3+ legs, minimum $1 bet required. Refund issued as non-withdrawable free bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Max free bet, $5. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Go passionately. Go fearlessly. Go confidently.
Go Birds!
Go confidently towards your goals with First Trust, Philly's hometown bank for nearly 90 years, and the official bank of the Philadelphia Eagles. We're focused on getting you over the goal line. So go with conviction. Go with trust.
Go Birds!
And go forward with us by your side. First Trust Bank, the official bank of Philadelphia dreams. Oh, and go Birds.
Thanks for the coffee.
No problem. With my cash rewards card from Navy Federal Credit Union, I get up to 1.75% cash back.
Isn't it 1.5%?
Now it's up to 1.75%.
That's bigger!
And better! I bought these scones with my cash back! I love scones! Me too! Scones for everyone!
When you sign up for direct deposit, you can earn up to 1.75% cash back with the Cash Rewards Card. Learn more at NavyFederal.org. Navy Federal Credit Union. Our members are the mission. Insured by NCUA.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly!
It's Super Start Battery Month at O'Reilly Auto Parts. Get up to a $25 gift card after a mail-in rebate with the purchase of select Super Start batteries. For power, performance, and reliability, choose Super Start batteries. We also have battery solutions for many hybrid and electric vehicles. Stop by your local O'Reilly Auto Parts today.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Hockey's even more exciting with the Bet Rivers Sportsbook app. Score big with same-game parlays where you can combine different bets from the same game, like the money line, check, puck line, check, and player props, check. Plus, with award-winning customer service, you'll never miss a shift. Download the Bet Rivers Sportsbook app on iOS and Android. It's a whole new game.
Must be 21 plus. Available in Pennsylvania only. Void where prohibited. Terms and conditions apply. Presented by Rivers Casino Pittsburgh. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
By the time you're finished listening to this Pepsi Zero Sugar, you'll be 15 seconds closer to kickoff. Stock up now because game day is so close, you can almost taste it. Football watching. Better with Pepsi.
Philly, we're big fans of keeping you healthy. With Health Fanatics by Virtua Health, explore exclusive articles, expert insights, and so much more. Visit 975thefanatic.com/virtua.
Hey guys, Andrew, you need your roof replaced? Well, there's one place for you to call. It's New Look Home Design. They've installed over 40,000 roofs. So on average, that's one roof every hour. So you know that they have the experience and professionalism that you're looking for. And they don't do it, you know, just, you know, roof after roof after roof just because they can. It's because other people talk about New Look Home Design, which, you know, people get their roof done by New Look and they tell their neighbors about it. And that's why they've reached over 40,000 roofs. And they do so much for you to make your life easy. They offer you same day on-site or virtual estimates, whatever's best for you. They provide a 3D rendering of your home showing you exactly what your new roof is going to look like. And every estimate includes line-by-line pricing, so you know exactly what you're paying for. And in my opinion, best of all, they will offer you a lifetime warranty, which means they stand behind their work. You're not going to find better people to do your roof. So if you call right now or visit them online, newlookhomedesign.com right now, you can save 50% on all roofing projects and qualify for no payments, no interest financing for 12 months. All right, so 50% off. Plus, you qualify to get your new roof now and make no payments for a full year with the holiday season coming up, you know, right around the corner. That's huge for your wallets. Also, because the Fightins are in the NLCS, hopefully in the World Series, you're going to be paying money for tickets. The Birds are 6-0. You're going to want to pay tickets for that. You're going to want to buy tickets for the Sixers and the Red Hot Flyers and the Union. So you don't have to pay for your roof. That's great. If you need a new roof, get it done right with New Look Home Design. Call 800-279-5300. That's 800-279-5300. Or visit them online, newlookhomedesign.com. That's NULookHomeDesign.com. And tell them Andrew sent you.
More of the Anthony Gargano Show now
on 97.5 The Fanatic.
All right, welcome back. Buzz Radio with the tune is 12:30, 12 o'clock hour, brought to you by our good friends at Service First Heating and Air Conditioning. That's Brian. Check it out, servicefirsthvac.com. All right. What a the one good thing about this whole weekend is that Birds are 6-0. It's a bye week, and we can concentrate on the fightings on the Red October. Joining us as he does every Thursday, he's the best, the great insider working the NFL from the NFL Network, South Philadelphia born and bred, my man Mike Garofolo. Mikey G.
I love that screen grab, that awful announcing use. Did you see that one of you?
No, I didn't see that.
You got, come on. So they were doing Philly sports is blowing up right now, and Philly radio is loving it, and it's a picture of you in mid-scream, in your open the other day. So I love that one.
I act like an idiot. I don't care either. It's just the greatest time of the year. Mike, you know what it's like, right? So the Phillies, this is a gift. This whole run is awesome. I mean, I know you're following it.
So what's funny to me, and listen, it feels like it's been a while, right? But what's funny to me is like, oh, man, they hadn't made the postseason in a decade or 11 years. What is it? Right. I don't even remember. When I grew up, and how many years was it? Like 83 to 93,
yeah,
right? Like 13, that felt like an eternity. To me, it was like, wow, it's really been that long. It's been as long as it had been before. But you got to remember, I had never experienced it. I'm in 83. I was only 3 years old. So,
right.
This time around, I'm like, wow, it didn't feel like as long, but because before it had been forever to me.
And think about it. In that year, I mean, like, they never won it. And then from 93 to 07, like, that's a huge chunk of time, right? Baseball kind of died for a while here, right?
Listen, in those years, I was producing for you and for other shows and was told, even in the dead of summer, let's not talk baseball, right? Like,
don't talk baseball. Michael, don't talk baseball. Yeah. That's what we heard. And we, how mad I used to get. Remember that?
Wow. But you would get mad because there would be flickers and signs of hope. Yeah. And we'd be in, May, and the team would still be hanging in there, and then they would fade. It struck me the other day that, the drought is just as long as it was from 83 to 93, but to me it felt so much longer back then. I just couldn't believe that it felt. Now, listen, I'm older, I got kids, I got a lot of things going on.
Right,
back
right.
then, I was locked into sports and only sports.
You're hanging the Fladium. That was it.
But they did a thing on Good Morning Football today about, which town is experiencing the better renaissance right now. Is it New York or Philly? And, Schrager, Mr. Freehold, and, Brooklyn now, he picked New York. And I'm like, no way, man. You should see what's going on in Philly. You should feel the vibe. I was down there right now. Now, listen, it's also a football show, so you got two football teams in New York that right now are playing well, so it lends more to the conversation for that show. So I get it, but, man, I wanted to be on the panel today to fight that battle.
Yeah, well, I mean, not for nothing. It's a football show, right? I don't know. The Eagles are 6-0. Were they down there at Lincoln Financial Field Sunday night against the Cowboys? That place.
No,
was
but I'm just saying
the
storyline he was pushing was when's the last time the Jets and the Giants at the same time?
Yeah,
were hot. I worked up there.
They used to cut Subway Super Bowl. Subway Super. Yes. Both teams would be 2-0. They'd be talking Subway Super Bowl. Stop. The Giants are fugazi. Right. Tell me what the Giants are doing. Listen, I love the coach. The coach is great. Are they a team that you really got to pay attention to?
Well, at this point, they're going to make the playoffs. It seems hard for them to not make the playoffs just because of what the record is right now and how soft their schedule. I mean, and I think I said this before to you, their schedule is Charmin soft. I mean, they've got, so the next four games are not as easy as they first looked. Like when we looked at this a month ago or even before the season, we thought, oh man, look at this stretch of games they've got. They've got the Jaguars this week, They've got Seattle the week after. Now, both of those games are on the road, and both of them are against teams that are proven to be much more trouble than we thought coming into the season, right? So that's one thing. Then they get a bye. And then coming out of the bye, I forget the order, I think it's Houston and then Detroit. If you look at those four games, it's Jacksonville, Seattle, Houston, Detroit. They, you know, you hate to start putting expectations on a team that's surprising. They should go 3-1. Huh. There's no reason why they can't go 3-1. So now they're 8-2 if that happens. Now, listen, I've been around long enough to know they'll probably go 1-3. That's the way it works.
Right,
expectations.
Right.
So you can't just – but there's winnable games, and I think this stretch is going to tell us because they're not talented yet, man. It's got wide receivers that aren't running the right – stuff and their timing is off. They can't get the offense down, but they're coached really well. They're playing really smart football, and you play real smart football in this league. I honestly, I'm not going to start questioning guys that have been at this for decades and work 18 hours a day. But sometimes I scratch my head when I watch the Giants. I don't scratch my head. I think this is exactly the kind of stuff they should be doing to make them play smart football.
I agree. I just think they're well coached like that. I'm completely with you. You know, it's funny because the Eagles are 6-0, Mike, and I look at, you know, and I watch the league, and it, you know, whatever is what it is. And then somebody was talking to me inside the league, and they were like, "Yo, dude, this league is not good, right?"
Yeah.
And I gotta ask you because going into this Thursday night game, like, what's up with the league? Why is it not any good?
Well, it's the downside of parity, Ant, right? If you want, I was just at the league meetings the other day. They're talking about the average margin of victory right now is like 8.9 or something like that in that area.
Right.
It's the lowest since like the 1930s, right? And they even they said it's not going to hold. It's going to reverse to the mean. But they're celebrating it, right? This is what they want. They want these competitive games. Now, the problem with that is, It brings the bad teams up, but it brings the good teams down. There's not dominant football anymore. That's why I'm saying when I watch the Giants and I see a team that doesn't shoot itself in the foot, I think that's very rare in this league. It's really hard to do that. I mean, like, we could sit there, and I know what you're saying, and I know what whoever you were talking to was saying. This Eagles team is very imperfect. There's a lot of things they're doing second half scoring-wise that are problems. You know, they've got a quarterback that we're not quite sold on that we need to see more from. It's a very incomplete team, and I know that there was somebody did the power rankings the other day, and they were second, and people were angry about it. And I'm saying, how could you be angry about it? If they went to Buffalo right now, do you think they'd be favored? Would you give them a chance to win that game? I'd give them a chance. I wouldn't pick them.
I mean, listen, so, I guess when that guy told me that, I was like, you know, listen, I think Eagles are good, and I think they're tough, and I think they're well coached, and you know, I defended them right to the guy. But he was really talking about some of the wretched football, like Washington, Chicago last week, right?
Yeah,
you know, the Broncos. These teams, the offensive lines are horrible. Like, nobody can protect. The Cardinals, the team you're going to see tonight. I mean, just bad football. The Rams aren't any good. And how bad are the Panthers?
Yeah. No, it's a lot of bad football. And we're in a run of Thursday night games that are just not the kind that you draw up when you're trying to sell a big Amazon Thursday night football package. So, and it's like, it's not even like, you know, we've gotten two bad teams playing each other. It's not like, I remember there was a game last year, Patriots, Falcons, and it was a complete mismatch. And I think the Patriots shut them out. And it's like, we haven't had those games. We've had, you know, two Falcons caliber teams playing each other instead of the mismatch, which is, I don't know if it's better because the games are closer, but it's two bad teams. And it's like, does anybody want to win this game right now?
So, right.
Yeah. You're getting into a bigger conversation, which is, you know, the way the league is structured right now, not just with the parity, but also the restrictions on what you're doing in the spring and the summer and the lack of contact in practices. And, you know, you bring this up to the Players Association and they tell you that's a complete joke. It's all the coaches are saying because the coaches are, you know, excusing their poor coaching technique and all this stuff. And it's like, I don't know. I think you work hard at any craft. I think back when you had two-a-days, it was beating on guys' bodies, but the technique was better. The fundamentals were better because you had more time to practice it. But by the same token, if this means that players are going to be healthy for decades after they play, I feel much better about this as a fan and someone covering the sport. You know, if this is going to lead them to live healthier lives and we sacrifice some good football, I'm fine with that.
Yeah. No, when it comes to you give me that choice, I'm completely with you. I was just remarking and with this dude we were just talking about, and he brought it up because he's like your boys type of thing. Because I was kind of crowing a little bit, going, "Hey, they're pretty good." And he goes, other than Buffalo, I mean, Buffalo is a great team. I mean, they're so well coached, they're so dominant.
Yeah.
I think Kansas City's legit. Who would you put up after Buffalo, Kansas City, the Eagles? Who do you like?
Well, Buffalo is the only complete team, right? Like you can,
right.
Kansas City's really good. Are they complete? No, you know. So Buffalo's just on a tier by itself right now.
And, right.
You know, you go back to the NFC. You know, when Jimmy took over as quarterback, I said, "Oh, watch out! Here come the 49ers." The 49ers just lost by, I think, 14 to the Falcons. Like, they haven't risen up the way that I kind of hoped. Nobody in that NFC West that we thought was tough. The AFC West, which we thought was going to be this shootout, is really becoming. Now, I think right now the overall records are tied with the Chargers and the Chiefs. But
right.
You know, you're certainly not seeing four teams. You're seeing Kansas City. And I would expect them to be the one standing in the end without much of a contest from folks. So, to me, your question is not really the right one. I think it's Buffalo by itself, and then I got a chunk of maybe four or five teams that I don't know that I really trust going anywhere to win a game.
Yeah, guess what? I hear you. I feel like it was funny.
But I kind of like that because, you know, recently in the NFL, it's been like, all right, there's this cluster of teams at the top, and who could really emerge? I kind of like the fact that we've got one team that's really standing out from the crowd, and, you know, let's see if they can take on all comers now and through January and February.
So who's there? There's always a team that rises in, like, the second half of the season, right? Like, once you hit the November, December, there's always that riser. Who's your forecast? Like, who do you see maybe being scary November, December?
Yeah, I'll give you the two teams, okay? And I could be way wrong, and they could be just completely average and just never rise up. It's the 49ers in the NFC because they always seem to get stronger as the season goes on, and they're a team you don't want to face in the playoffs, okay? So that's my NFC team. And my AFC team, and I may live to regret this, but I've said it before, so I'm sort of pot committed on this one, is the Colts. You know, I'm stunned at how bad Matt Ryan has been. Absolutely bored.
Now, I watched the game against Denver.
Yeah.
He didn't have a lot of time. How's that line been in front of him?
Yeah, which is the problem because that line. Listen, I much prefer when I make these calls to be picking the team with the strong offensive line because that's usually something that leads to winning football in the NFL. And it's like, okay, everything else you can kind of cover up. You can't cover up a bad offensive line. It's really hard to do that. So, you know, maybe they make some kind of move that makes me feel better about it. They acquire a tackle via trade. I mean, the trade deadline is going to be really interesting because more to your point about the quality of these teams, there's a lot of teams that I look at and say, oh boy, this team needs this.
Right.
You know, they really need pass rushers or they need. Yeah, so I find this funny about, you know, Cam Akers and these running backs that might be available, Christian McCaffrey. These teams out there have way more needs than running back, okay?
You can get
by with a running back. Any team that's out there buying at the trade deadline on running back is wasting their time and it's wasting their draft capital, unless you're really getting a bargain-type deal. Now, the other thing is maybe the Eagles, because that's a team that added the power runner in LeGarrette Blount the Super Bowl year, right? And I think it could make a lot of sense if they try to do that. So maybe I'm saying this now. If the Eagles trade for a running back, that's a different situation. I'm talking about some of these other teams that have been
connected
to McCaffrey and whatnot. So, you know, if the Colts make a move at the offensive line to bring in a tackle, that could make a lot of sense and that would make me feel better about them. So anyway, they're my AFC team that they're in the rearview mirror, but they're not that far away that they're going to disappear, and you better keep an eye on them.
All right, how about you? You brought it up, and it was on my list to talk to you about. that the deadline with the Eagles. And you know, Trader Howie is a guy who's bold. What do you expect out of him?
I'm not sure what they need. It's just, where's the hole in the roster?
I know.
I don't see one. I know.
Well, you mentioned and I was thinking about running back, but that's really it. You know.
Yeah, I mean, that's the one that I would think that they would be, you know, maybe they'll and somebody tried to connect them to Cam Akers.
Right.
And I don't think Akers is their guy. But you know, maybe Howie's nosing around. Yeah, you got to get it for nothing, right? You're not giving up.
And Howie will not give up. I agree. Like, you can't give up anything of merit. Like, you got to be able to steal somebody. That's it.
Well, he's got tradable pieces, and you know, Andre Dillard's a guy that I remember keep checking on him, but they're not giving him away. I understand he's a backup, but to them, it's value and a guy that they still think can flourish and play. So, it's not like
he sees these offensive lines around football and says, "I got depth. I need depth." The last thing I'm going to do is trade away a piece, and then God forbid I get an injury later in the season, and when I could have used them. So I agree with you. I don't think he's moving them.
Which is why, you know, I think if he moves Dillard, it's for some kind of value draft pick wise. I don't know that, you know, getting a running back is enough for him. Yeah. And that might, somebody might be listening and saying, that's crazy. We can get a good downhill physical runner and a guy that can contribute, but you're going to keep a guy on the bench. Listen, there's something to be said for, we've got a piece, we value him. What year is he in? Does he have one more year in his contract?
Yeah, he's
got one remember more. Off the top of my head.
Yeah.
So that makes sense. So now you can carry it into the offseason, and maybe you get value for him in a deal this offseason. You go back to the drawing board there.
I'm with you. Mikey, great stuff as always. Big weekend, Red October with the birds by. So I know you'll have one eye on the fighting Phils.
Yeah, what time? Do we know what time Sunday game would be?
Yeah, 2:30.
Okay, that's 2:37. Not ideal, but whatever. We'll make it work. I got enough computers and screens, and I can do screens within screens. Well, it'll be there somewhere. Let's go, Phil.
I like it. I love it. Thanks, my brother. Great stuff.
You know, I'm going head to head with Daniel Jeremiah, who's a big Padres fan. You know, that's my guy at NFL Network. Move the sticks and. He's, you know, you usually think Padres fans, Southern California, laid back. He gets intense. So
really?
As the series gets deeper, you know, we may start jawing back and forth on Twitter and otherwise.
All right, well, you know, you need a backup. I got you. You know that. I always have you. Always got your back. You know that, my brother.
I would ask for no more than you having my back, my friend.
I love you, buddy. Listen, enjoy the game, man. You're the best. Mike Garofalo. NFL Network on the Comcast Business Hotline. We'll come back, Geek, to get you started with your fantasy weekend. As always, we need a little geekish action. He's coming up next, Cuz Radio with the Chunas, 97.5 The Fanatic.
And this is Andrew Sal Chunas. Start NFL Week 7 off with a no-sweat same-game parlay from FanDuel in partnership with Valley Forge. Whether you're new to FanDuel or not, get free bets back. If your Thursday night same-game parlay doesn't hit, same-game parlays combine bets for a chance at a bigger payday. And I think we finally get some points today. I think we actually have somewhat of an entertaining Thursday night game. They've been bad the last couple of weeks. You got the Cards and you got the Saints, and I think you have some locks for some anytime touchdown scores. Alvin Kamara, pretty much all the offense for New Orleans right now. And DeAndre Hopkins makes his return after the suspension tonight. So D-Hop and Alvin Kamara, I think, are two guys you want to go with the anytime touchdown score. Look at James Conner, whether or not he plays. He's a guy that they can give the ball to in the red zone. And, of course, with Hopkins back, Kyler Murray's over in passing yards. Build yours or choose from one of the popular pre-built SGPs, however you want to play. Bet the NFL on Thursday night with a no-sweat same-game parlay. Bet the NFL on Thursday night, again, with a no-sweat same-game parlay. Have that written twice. Sign up with promo code Fanatics, and whether you're new to FanDuel or a current user, you are all set. Just download the app with promo code Fanatic and make every moment more with FanDuel, an official sports betting partner of the NFL. You got to be 21 plus and present in PA. 3+ legs, minimum $1 bet required. Refund issues, non-withdrawable free bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Max free bet, $5. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem, call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Fanatic Sports Update.
Series tied at one. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this update is brought to you by the Valley Forge Tourism and Convention Board. Sip and explore your way through Montgomery County. Visit MoncoMakersPassport.com for your free passport. That'll take you to the best breweries, wineries, and distilleries in the area. Plus, earn prizes along the way. That's MoncoMakersPassport.com. The Phillies and Padres tied at one win apiece after the Phillies blew a 4-0 lead yesterday. Padres win 7-5. Game 3 now in South Philadelphia. Also, games 4 and 5. They'll all take place at Citizens Bank Park. They're off today. Game 3 is tomorrow. Ranger Suarez getting the start against Joe Musgrove. Ranger Suarez bested Musgrove earlier this year. Hopefully, he can do that again tomorrow night. Sixers back in action tonight after having yesterday off. It is their home debut of the 2022 season. They host the Milwaukee Bucks. Tip off at 7:30. And the Union begin their quest to the Cup after having a bye. They host Cincinnati tonight at 8 o'clock. This update is also brought to you by the Philadelphia Museum of Art. Matisse in the 1930s, now at the Philadelphia Museum of Art. Learn how creating a mural for Philadelphia helped Matisse get his mojo back. Open late Fridays. Book tickets at PhillyMuseum.com. Hopefully Matisse can get his mojo from three. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this is 97.5 The Fanatic.
It's the Anthony Gargano Show on 97.5 The Fanatic.
Hi, guys. It's Andrew with Oak Hills Medical Clinic. Are you struggling with ED and sick of the pills? Well, we have a major medical breakthrough that has helped thousands of men. Our wave technology is backed by 50 clinical studies, including from Cambridge University. It's proven to increase blood flow by repairing blood vessels. No pills and no side effects. If you're ready to put a stop to your ED and turn back the clock in the bedroom, call us now. And not only will the assessment and blood flow ultrasound be free, we'll also include something unique that produces immediate results in the bedroom. I don't think I've ever heard of it failing. This offer is worth $600, but it's free to those that call in the next 2 minutes. 215-302-9999. That's 215-302-9999. Guys, put a stop to your ED and get your love life back. Call Oak Hills Medical Clinic now to qualify for this unprecedented offer. 215-302-9999.
The Fall Car Fest of Savings is going on right now at Jeff D'Ambrosio, Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram in Destination Downingtown. And Jeff keeps saying, yes, you can. Jeff says, yes, you can find the car, truck, or SUV you want in stock today. Why wait for a new vehicle and overpay when Jeff has over 1,000 Jeeps, Rams, and more in stock? Jeff says, yes, you can get low leases and big discounts with new 2023 Grand Cherokees or 22 Ram 1500s starting at $225 per month for 24 months. Or take over $10,000 off MSRP on select models. Jeff says, yes, you can still get 0% financing, zero down, and low payments. And Jeff says, yes, you can get top dollar for any trade or get out of that current lease months early. Credit problem? Jeff says yes. Jeff's goal is 100% credit approval, no matter how bad your credit is. When the other dealers say no, Jeff D'Ambrosio always says, yes, you can. It's the Fall Car Fest of Savings going on now at Jeff D'Ambrosio Destination Downingtown. Call 610-269-9500 or gojeffauto.com. If you want it for less, you gotta see Jeff. Tell him Andy Summer sent you. Jeep Adventure Days.
In all of esports, there's few rivalries bigger than North America versus Europe in League of Legends. For 8 years, North America has never won an international best of series against Europe. The last time North America even took a single map off of a European team was in 2013. As of this week, the curse has been broken. Evil Geniuses stomped Mad Lions 3-0 in the League of Legends World Play-Ins.
The latest esports and gaming news. Find it online at CheckpointXP.com.
Businesses don't run on automation or algorithms alone. What powers businesses are your people and the people they serve. At Cintas, your dedicated service reps understand what you need to help you keep your employees feeling safe, comfortable, and performing their best, so your business can too. For workwear, essential cleaning products, first aid and safety supplies, and fire protection services, visit Cintas.com.
Oh, I'm ready!
And get ready for the workday.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're speaking another language, like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
Babbel.
Babbel. Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
Ew. Stuck in a cycle of rewashing your clothes?
Ugh.
Because you can't remove tough laundry odor?
Ugh.
When detergent by itself can't cut it, use new Downy Rinse and Refresh.
With a breakthrough odor-removing formula, it removes odors in one wash, better than the leading value detergent in three washes, keeping all your laundry fresh. Mmm. Now you can break the cycle of rewashing. With Downy Rinse and Refresh.
Okay, three more climbers, seven loggers.
Ted's sustainably sourced logging company is growing a new branch.
What about truck driver contracts?
Which means a new HR manager will be the first hire to fall.
Then we'll need to staff up the warehouse.
Indeed can help him hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
If you're wondering if your furnace is going to last through the winter, don't chance it. It's John Kincaid for H&H Heating and Air Conditioning. Trust H&H for a thorough system checkup before winter. We had ours last week, and with H&H's $59 gas furnace tune-up, including the carbon monoxide safety check, you're going to have peace of mind before the cold. If you need a new system, H&H has rebates of up to $1,500 or 0% financing for 18 months for qualified buyers. Visit DelcoHVAC.com to schedule your $59 tune-up or new system estimate today. That's DelcoHVAC.com.
Hey! To become the next generation of innovators, entrepreneurs, and creators, we're gonna need something.
Like a high-speed internet connection that can turn my ideas into reality.
Like the skills to become the world's most powerful coder.
Like the tools to start my sustainable shoe business.
You just heard some of the millions of students Comcast is supporting through Project Up, our comprehensive initiative and $1 billion commitment to open doors for the next generation so they can build a future of unlimited possibilities. Learn more at Comcast.com/Project Up.
Hey, this is Brian, and I'm the owner of Valley Grove Construction. We're expanding our team and hiring skilled and creative carpenters. As a company that truly values its talented carpenters, we prove it with top dollar pay starting at $30 an hour, an aggressive 401k plan, a generous vacation package, paid holidays, and even a $100 weekly travel allowance. You heard me right. That's over $5,000 a year to help with gas and vehicle expenses. If you're tired of not working with great people or just not doing the skilled work that you're capable of, then apply today at valleygroveconstruction.com. That's valleygroveconstruction.com. And click the Join Our Team link.
Hey guys, Bob Cooney here. Plan your game days at Live Casino and Hotel Philadelphia, the ultimate game day watch party headquarters, presented by Bud Light. Catch all the action at Sports and Social or Center Bar with giveaways, contests, and special alumni appearances. Sip on specialty cocktails at the Prime Rib. Try Philly favorites with a twist at Luck Fu, like cheesesteak egg rolls or the Philly Roll. Plus, enjoy $5 Bud Lights every game. Game days at Live, presented by Bud Light. To learn more, visit livecasinophilly.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
WPEN, Burlington, Philadelphia. A Beasley Media Group station. Home of the most entertaining sports talk in Philadelphia. 97.5, The Fanatic, Philadelphia.
Smooth. All right, 1 o'clock across the Delaware Valley. 1 o'clock, can you believe it? Cuz Radio Tunis. And, you know, listen, this time of the day, we always like to geek it out. Now, Tunis and I always are major geeks. But it's time for you fantasy geeks. I need you guys because your hero has arrived. It's the one, the only, Geek. What do you say, Geekus?
What's going on, cuz? What's going on, fellas?
My man. Hey, listen, by the way, if you have a question for the Geek, start sick question before we dive into it. You know, you got to hit me up, Anthony Lewis Gargano on Instagram, DM me, or on Twitter at Anthony L. Gargano. You got A. Sal Tunis at ASALTUNIS975 on Instagram or Twitter. And Geek, what's yours? Just so people have it.
You can always hit me up at FFootballGeek on Twitter. I'm not on the Instagram.
You got to go on the gram, Bo.
I don't understand
that's you,
the gram.
Man. You got to go on the gram.
Not on the gram, but at FFootballGeek on Twitter. I'll get those sit starts in. Because I've got something for the listeners today.
You always have something good.
I don't show up empty-handed. I come bearing
gifts. You never
gifts.
Do. You are. You're a tremendous guy. People have no idea what a great guy you are.
A generous guy. So yes. Here's the gift. I'm going to give you the gift of doing well on your fantasy football league. That's the greatest gift you can give anybody.
That's right.
And so I've got a couple plays here based on some of the happenings and some sneaky, sneaky ads for people that you can actually still pick up. So, you know, one of the big pieces of news this week, and I don't know if you guys have covered it on the show much, but what's going on with Cam Akers? I don't know what's happening over there in L.A.
Oh, wow.
He's like, yeah, yeah, we don't like you anymore.
I just had Mike Garafolo from the NFL Network on. He's out. That's it.
One day we'll find out what happened, right? Mm-hmm. We have not. I don't know. You know, at some point we'll find out what happened, but it's irrelevant. So here's what we know about the team, though. Number one, Darrell Williams, never been a very durable running back. Guy gets hurt a lot. So, and they did draft a player this year that has a lot of potential in Kyren Williams. Kyren Williams out of, I believe it was Notre Dame. Good pass catcher.
Uh-huh.
Was regarded as one of the top four running backs coming out of the draft class until he tested kind of poorly in the combine. A little slump. But who cares? He's on the team, and he's available for free in your league. You don't even have to waste a waiver, nothing. He's there now, and you could just pick him up. If you have an IR spot, he's going to be probably on IR another week or so, so you can potentially stash him. But Kyren Williams down the road, could you not just see Darrell Williams getting hurt? And
yes,
then Kyren is leading you to a fantasy championship.
Yes.
Got to think ahead, right?
Wow, you're a genius.
I got more for you, Cuz. I got more. That's just one. I got more. So everybody is in tight end hell this week. Everybody. You know, all the goats, including my boy Dallas Goedert, as you know. He's out. Bye week. Right? A lot of trouble at the tight end position. So got a couple names you could pick up right now. Fill in for you this week and maybe have some interest beyond. And one of them is Daniel Bellinger from the New York Football Giants, where I'm at 5 for 5 last week. He's on the field 90% of the time. And, you know, it's not like the Giants have wide receivers, so they might as well throw it to the tight end. I mean, they got nothing. Same note, actually, on the Giants, Wandale Robinson might be an interesting pickup if you're in need of a wide receiver this week. Again, he's available. You could just pick him up. You don't even have to waste a roster spot, a waiver, or any fob on him. So that's a really nice, interesting pickup. Wandale did what he was in there to do last week, and I think his participation will continue to increase in that offense. And one other one is Foster Moreau at tight end. If you need a tight end and, you know, Bellinger's not working out for you, I think Waller is
from the island of Foster Moreau.
The island of Foster Moreau. That's right. I got one last one. Look, the Isle of Foster Moreau. You remember. I love it. So the last one is Kenyon Drake, a.k.a. the Dreezy. Drake, you know, I don't know what's going on with J.K. Dobbins either, but the guy hasn't been very good. And, you know, he comes out of the game, knee issues last week. Kenyon Drake comes in looking real good. And you know who the worst team against the running back position is on the season? It'll surprise you.
Who?
The Browns.
Yeah, that does surprise me. Yeah, that does.
It's a little surprising, I'll be honest. Yeah. It's surprising for me too. You know, the other bad ones are Houston. I mean, there's a few bad ones, but the Browns are actually 32nd. They are DVOA worst, and I don't know why. I traditionally they haven't been, but I'll take a shot on Kenyon Drake this week if I need it. I mean, bye weeks are brutal this week. You have the Bills out and the Eagles, all the fun teams.
Yeah, what a good football. We were talking about the direct, some of the league direct. How's that been affecting your DFS, like, you know, that sort of thing, especially like when you do the captains and that sort of thing, the showdowns?
The showdown aside, because, you know, we love our showdowns. That's like a specialty of my person, right? Love the showdowns.
He wrecks all those contests, man. He's the man.
Yeah, we destroy showdowns at DFS. It is by far the best thing that we do, and we really embrace it. So single game Thursday and Sunday night, Monday nighters. But so, you know, those are fine. We've been playing a lot of kickers and defenses in these horrible games. You know, something's going on in this league, but the biggest effect of the badness of the league overall has been in, you know, when we play daily fantasy, a big part of it was always game stacking, building these giant correlated sort of teams around a particular game. That really hasn't worked very well this year. There was a couple of games earlier in the season, that crazy game with Detroit and Seattle, for example. And Detroit's been a part of a lot of those kind of games, which, by the way, is just something to keep in mind. You always kind of want to have a piece of Detroit and whoever they're up against. But it's really harmed the game stack. So this year what I've done is I've shifted my play, and this really started last year with all the badness in the league last year. And the problem is there's no good quarterbacks. There's really only 8 or 9 acceptable quarterbacks in the NFL today, and the rest are just regressing or just terrible.
Yeah, a lot of garbage, so, I mean, right? A lot of garbage.
I mean, listen, I'm not trying to Russell Wilson's kind of dust, isn't he? I mean, he looks terrible.
He's dust. Yeah.
He's bad, and I'm sorry, Tom Brady, you're the GOAT. I love you. I'll always appreciate you. I love him in the way that I love, you know, Michael Jordan for making my life miserable as a Jets fan or a Knicks fan. You know what I mean? Like, I love him in that GOAT way. But he, you know, made me miserable. But, like, something's off about Tom Brady, too. You know, he's not playing the way he did the last few years. And I think he can snap out of it. But we just had a lot of bad QB play. Aaron Rodgers is not playing well. So even the good quarterbacks are kind of playing poorly. And then, of course, the bad ones are just playing terribly. So it ends up with the league with just 5 or 6 good teams and the rest kind of all very mediocre.
Yeah. Yeah,
not creating competitive.
Speaking of mediocre tonight, man, between these two squads, the world is Arizona.
That's another guy, right? Kyler Murray. What? How do you get worse? You're a young quarterback. You're supposed to get better each year.
I know.
You know, you come back off an offseason. Now, Jalen Hurts comes back after an offseason. Guy looks leveled up like he's Josh Allen light out there, right? He's like, whoa, this guy got a lot better. This offseason, he's delivering the ball. Like, ooh, I'm seeing visual improvements in the game. It's the exact opposite with with Murray. The guy gets visibly worse every year.
Yeah.
What's he doing?
Yeah,
I don't know. I got to turn it around.
All right. I got a lot of people.
I got to turn it around.
A lot of people want to talk to you, as always. So let's get it going. Mr. Everywhere says, question for the geek, Robert Tonyan or Gerald Everett? At tight end, in tight end hell, go Phils.
Man, I like both of those guys. You got to play Tonyan, though. I think he had 10 targets last week.
Uh-huh.
Gerald Everett now. Well, actually, watch for Don Parham. So I know this seems a little obscure, but if Don Parham is out, I'm actually going to go back to Gerald Everett. I really like that game.
Okay.
But if Parham plays, Everett really just split time with Parham last week, so I would say I would actually go with Tonyan, who, you know, they don't have anyone else to throw to in Green Bay, so he gets a lot of targets now.
All right, Vince says, do I need a flex? Corey Davis, Chris Olave, or Josh Reynolds?
I just want to – I'm glad he asked this so I can emphatically state how much I love Olave.
Yeah.
Tonight, I just love him. He will be one of the top stars. You know, so, yes, definitely Olave. He's the only – guy that they could throw. I think Jameis Winston's going to come back tonight. It's not definitive yet.
Right.
Announced anything, but I think it will be Winston. But I love Olave here. He's the only target. He's the only game in town. I already bet a few different props on Olave, a few different overs.
All right. So my man, the wrong world, who's got incredible ceramics and everything else, and says, can you ask the geeks, I need two of these three, St. Brown, Hopkins, or Godwin?
You know, the one I'm going to sit is Hopkins. And it's just because it's his first game back. Listen, this isn't coming back off injury. He's going to be fine. But actually, more of the reason is because Kyler Murray's not good. I like all three of them. I would be very comfortable starting all three of them. And I know when Hopkins is burning a hole on your bench all season, you can't wait to play him, right?
Right.
So he can't wait. But, I mean, it's Amon-Ra and it's Godwin. I'm starting those guys over Hopkins this week.
All right, my man Eddie Wright says, Kenyon Drake or Eno? Eno, because you were all Eno'd up last week.
Eno disappointed us last week, but, you know, I'm giving him a pass. You know, the Cardinals just don't produce a lot of fantasy points to the running back position. I don't know how much of it is Eno not being very good. It's just the way the team operates, them creating points to that position. Listen, here's the issue. We don't know if J.K. Dobbins is going to play or not. I would not. It's scary to risk it, but I'd much rather play a Kenyon Drake if he's getting the role this week than Eno in this spot in a really tough matchup against a good defense that is even better against the run. So I think I might roll the dice and go with Kenyon. But, you know, if Dobbins does play, it's going to be less good than we were hoping.
All right. Vince Flaherty says, Curtis Samuel or James Robinson?
Man, James Robinson is tough to play. You got to go Curtis Samuel.
Okay.
Can't trust Robinson. I'm seeing a surge in sort of. I'm getting a little bit of tingles about ETN. Tingly about it.
All right, little tingles.
Feeling a surge coming on for him. Yeah, all a little Brees Hall level starting to take over. Maybe situation starting to brew. We'll see.
Okay. Michael Trexler asks, pick three of these four backs: Kamara, Aaron Jones, Kenneth Walker, Pierce.
Oh, man, I love them all. It's like choosing between your children. Can you do that? I mean, you got to play Kenny Walker this week. Kamara, I mean, I have to choose two. Pierce is great. I think the worst of them is Aaron Jones.
Okay.
So Aaron Jones would be on the bench for me. He is looking like low volume relative to the rest. You know, the other three will all get 20-plus touches. I like them all. One of those three.
Poor Adam Muhammad says, should I start Melvin Gordon or A.J. Dillon? As you can see, I'm hurting on running backs.
Yeah, that's rough. I think I'm on team Gordon is dead to me.
Gotcha.
I don't think I can play him. I just don't think you can play Melvin Gordon. The guy's fumbling twice a game. When he's not fumbling, he's bumbling. And when he's not bumbling, he's stumbling. It's horrible. You're playing. I'd rather have the half share from Dillon than whatever Gordon is doing out there. No, thank you.
All right. Matt wants to know, Michael Carter or Tyler Higbee, and should he trade Hollywood Brown?
I mean, yes. Hollywood Brown is not coming back. Forget Hollywood Brown. Somebody will give you anything for Hollywood Brown in a season long. You know, yeah, you should definitely trade him. I forgot the first. It was a really rough one. Carter or Higbee?
Yeah.
Ugh. Man, that's so gross. I guess it's Higbee. Higbee's getting targeted, so you're probably good for 7 or 8 targets for Higbee every week, and then can't figure out who else to throw to over there.
Coach Pete wants to know, Valdez Scantling or Corey Davis?
Yeah, I'm going Valdez Scantling here. Corey Davis does not have a great – I mean, Broncos, you don't want to test the Broncos' pass defense. I do like Corey Davis as probably the surprising best wide receiver on the Jets to kind of pair with Wilson, but I don't want anything to do with that this week, so we'll go with the other guy.
I gotcha.
Not Corey Davis.
Gotcha. Adam wants to know, do I start Tua or Carr? I got Jalen on a bye.
Yeah. I mean, these are good problems to have. I like Tua. The only fear I have with Tua, I like Tua over Carr. Carr's going to give you 17 fantasy points consistently every week. Tua has the ability to get you to 30 with those wide receivers and without having very much going on at the running back position. The only thing I'm worried about with Tua is, of course, you know, it's always scary to see a guy get hurt the way that he did. And like, oh, my God, what if he gets tackled and, you know, that happens again. You know, it's a little fear, but I think you can't play with that fear. I think you have to assume that a concussion type event, when it's over, and the player is back to full self.
I like it. Jared says, I need to start two of these three half PPR, Drake, Zeke, Mostert.
Okay. I think Mostert for sure. And again, between Drake and Zeke, I would much rather play Drake if he's getting the full workload. I'm probably leaning Drake anyway, but this is a good week. It's a good week for Zeke. Also, the return of Prescott, I think, will help that Dallas offense be a little bit more or will help them get to the goal line more frequently than they
were
when he wasn't there. And that's what Zeke needs. Zeke is not busting out big plays. You know, he's not catching it and running for 40. He's not busting out. He rarely runs for over 20 yards. He's just not that guy anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But he needs a team down by the goal line so he can smash him in. And if he gets two of those in a game, he's going to finally produce a really good score. And he's more likely to get those opportunities with a quality quarterback.
All right, Geekus, this from Bill, from Billy R. Billy says, Ramondre or Saquon?
So you're playing Saquon. I mean, I think that, you know, there's a chance that Harris will be back for Damian Harris will be back for the Patriots. I expect him to be back, which removes Ramondre from anything other than sort of a hope and pray kind of play. So, you know, with Damian Harris in there, it's Stevenson last week, but with half the touches. So, you know, you can't really trust him.
Clay says, would the Geek trade Cooper Kupp for Kamara and Eno?
Hell Eno. I would not.
Hell Eno. I love it.
Hell Eno. What? Cooper Kupp, they need to offer you the naming of their firstborn child. It's like, will you trade me Cooper Kupp for Eno Kamara and you get to name my kid? And I'd be like, all right. Worth it. Worth it.
All right.
Beyond that, you're not getting Cooper. You pry Cooper away from my cold, dead hands. No one's taking him from me.
Frank McJetters says, start Etienne, your tingles. Montgomery or Jeff Wilson? Pick two. Etienne, Montgomery, Jeff Wilson.
I know I had the tingles, but I'm taking the real starters.
Wow.
You got to go with the other guys. Got to go with Wilson and Montgomery. I know. I got the tingles, but that's not quite enough.
Dude, those tingles aren't enough, man.
No, not enough. Not enough. Yeah, if he said, or Tyler Higbee or something like that, I'll go, you know, I'll trust the tingle, but not, you know, you got to play the starting running back over sort of a slit guy.
Okay, I got you. All right, one more last one. This is from Ryan. Should he play Lamar or Burrow teamed up with Chase?
I don't care about the combination, to be honest with you, or correlation in a season-long league.
Okay.
So I'm going to play Lamar over Burrow pretty much every time. That's okay. Just, you know, his ceiling is just
banged up, right?
His ceiling is just so high. It's, you know, when Lamar in a game like this, when he does his thing, he's getting you 40. Burrow,
gotcha.
When he does his thing, he had his best game that he's going to have last week, you know, mid-30s. So there's a difference in the ceiling there, and the floors are about the same. So I'm going with Lamar.
All right. We're up against, do me a favor, tell us about the Sharp app, please. And
if people
want to get a hold of you and everything else to help with all their fantasy and betting.
The Sharp app is really just exploding right now, and you guys got to check it out. We have models for every game, and NBA in particular was where our Skynet AI prediction model shined last season. I'm already 7-3 on the or 7-3 on the season. And my track bets on the app, I'm just following the model plays and pretty much putting my stuff in there. So yeah, we constantly are adding to the app all of the metrics. We've got props. Our top props for last year for NBA was up 120 units tracked, and we're putting that out for free every day, the top props article. So make sure you download Sharp app. It's available on all the app stores, wherever you want it. You got me in there, and you got a team of really incredible sports bettors. They're fun. We have a good time. We make videos. You really want to check it out, and it's totally free. So make sure you download the Sharp app. And, of course, anybody wants to hit me up, I'm available on Twitter at FFootballGeek. I will answer your sit-start questions on there as well. Happy to do it, and we could just commiserate about our winnings or our losses, whatever you like. I'm out there.
You're the greatest. You really are. What a great guy, great demeanor. And you're our geek. We love you, buddy. Have a good luck this weekend, pal. I'm sure we'll be talking.
I appreciate it.
There he is, Geekus, and his Sharp app. We'll come back. Still another segment to hang. Cuz Radio. Tunis. Oh, I need a game. I need a Phillies game. Tunis. I need a Phillies game. 97.5 The Fanatic.
And this is Andrew Sal. Tune us tip off the NBA season with FanDuel in partnership with Valley Forge, America's number one sports book. Join today and get $150 in free bets guaranteed when you place your first $5 bet. Just sign up with promo code FANATIC and you get $150 once you make a $5 bet. Also, when you make a $5 bet, listen to this. All customers get 3 months of NBA League Pass when they make a $5 bet on the NBA. It's courtesy of FanDuel. That's awesome. Then you can watch all the action as you place bets on everything from money lines to point spreads and, of course, the three-point props, which I absolutely love. Best of all, you'll get your winnings paid instantly. So don't miss your chance to get $150 in free bets plus 3 months of NBA League Pass. That's really cool. All you have to do is put down $5 with promo code FANATIC, and you get all that. Make every moment more with FanDuel, the official sportsbook partner of the NBA. You got to be 21 plus and present in PA. New customers, first online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonus issued as non-drawable free bets that expire in 14 days. Existing customers, $5 NBA wager required. Limit one pass per customer across both offers. Restrictions apply. Void where prohibited. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Fanatic Sports Update.
Series tied at 1. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this update is brought to you by MedExpress. The thing about life, it doesn't care if you get sick. It doesn't care because it can't care, but MedExpress does. They offer treatment for the flu, strep, and more, all on your schedule. MedExpress, open 8 to 8 every day. No appointment necessary. The Phillies lost to the Padres yesterday, Game 2 in San Diego, 8 to 5. All right, it's all right. Series tied at 1 win apiece. Game 3 in South Philadelphia tomorrow night. Ranger Suarez gets the start for the Phils. He'll go up against Joe Musgrove. Suarez beat Musgrove earlier this year in June when things were going very well for the Phillies. Don't forget, Phillies split in Atlanta in the NLDS. So hopefully the good vibes continue for the Fightins. Games 4 and 5 also at Citizens Bank Park. But tonight we have Sixers action. Their home opener of the 2022 season. They host the Milwaukee Bucks. And at 8 o'clock, it's Union. The Philadelphia Union begin their quest to the MLS Cup. They host Cincinnati. Keep it locked in the Fanatic for all the latest news and information. I'm Andrew Salchunas, and this is 97.5 The Fanatic.
Anthony Gargano, weekdays 10 to 2 on 97.5 The Fanatic.
Everything I know about marijuana, I learned back when me and my friends had mullets. Yeah, I guess I got some catching up to do. And I'm curious about medical marijuana. It's legal in my state, I think. But is it right for me? Where can I get reliable, professional answers to my questions?
The answer to that question is VeriHeal, VeriHeal.com. Medical marijuana can be complicated, even confusing. You want trustworthy answers without jumping through hoops or waiting to see a doctor.
I'm a curious guy, but I'm a cautious guy too. I need trustworthy information, reliable answers to my questions. So VeriHeal sounds good. Tell me more.
VeriHeal.com is your single source for facts about medical marijuana and to pre-qualify online. Private and secure, quick and easy. Get started today with easy financing. VeriHeal. Convenience is why we're here. Trust is why we're number one. VeriHeal.com.
There's a reason Comcast Business powers more businesses than any other provider. Actually, there's a few. Comcast Business offers the fastest reliable network, the peace of mind that comes with Security Edge, helping to protect all your connected devices, and the most reliable 5G mobile network. Want me to keep going? I can. Whether your small business is starting or growing, you need Comcast Business. Technology solutions that put you ahead and give you serious savings. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
There's never been a better time to get gig speed internet and advanced security from Comcast Business. With our new gig bundles, you'll get 20% more speed for less. That's more value for your business and more speed to keep all your connected devices running smoothly. So get an incredible offer from the company that powers more businesses than anyone else. Call 1-800-501-6000 or go to comcastbusiness.com today to learn more. Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas. Comcast Business internet required. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed.
This week's Pro to Watch is brought to you by Bradford White. Bradford White water heaters are built to be the best. This week's Pros to Watch, how about the entire Sixers team? After an underwhelming finish last season that saw the Sixers fail to advance past the Eastern Conference semis again, they retooled the roster over the offseason with tougher, more versatile players. Embiid, Harden, Harris, and Maxey all returning as the core, adding P.J. Tucker, Daniel House Jr., De'Anthony Melton, and Montrezl Harrell. This revamped, stepped-up, new-look Sixers squad should be more equipped to do some damage in the East
possibly beyond. For exceptional hot water performance for your home or your business, ask a plumbing professional about installing a Bradford White water heater. Whether it's a gas or electric, tank or tankless, how you heat your water matters. So choose the quality, efficiency, and reliability of Bradford White for your starting lineup. To learn more and find a pro near you, visit bradfordwhite.com.
Hey, it's Tyrone Johnson. With a chill in the air this fall, my mind goes directly to snow blowers and generators. Lawn and Golf Supply in Phoenixville has 100 snow blowers in stock right now. Forget the big box stores. Lawn and Golf has an amazing selection of equipment. Let Lawn and Golf service your snow blower. Get it ready for winter weather. Fanatic listeners, mention this ad and get a special offer. Get ready for what's next. Snow blowers, generators, whatever you need to get you through the cold. Go to lawn-golf.com. That's lawn-golf.com.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack, but not with ZipRecruiter. Its powerful technology actively finds and invites qualified candidates to apply to your job. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you the needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Try ZipRecruiter for free at ziprecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
You could save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive, but when we just come out and say it, it feels like it falls a bit flat. So we're going to tap into human emotion, first with some music. Then in a serious tone, I'll say, save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive. And even though it was about saving money with Progressive, we'll fade out the music so you know it was poignant. Wow, powerful stuff. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Discount not available in all states or situations.
Hey, it's Cuz inviting you to join me, Chunis, and Charlie Manuel being Clearwater for the spring training trip of a lifetime with, of course, Philly Sports Trips. Get your deposit in now. Reserve your seats. We're staying at the beautiful Wyndham Grand. Heated pool, private beach, center of the action. We'll have an awesome weekend. Catch the Phils versus Toronto. Have a private event with the Skill. This is the trip you can't miss. Me, Chunis, and Charlie. Go to Philly Sports Trip.com now. Reserve your spot with a small deposit. PhillySportsTrip.com. Do it now. Go Flames.
Every drive starts somewhere. For First Trust Bank, our drive started in Philadelphia and continues to this day. As Philly's hometown bank for more than 85 years, we know this city's people. We understand their passions, and we work our tails off to help them reach their goals every day. Because Philadelphia dreams deserve a Philadelphia bank. First Trust Bank, the official bank of the Philadelphia Eagles. Member FDIC.
It's time for tip-off with basketball in the Bet Rivers Sportsbook app. Bet same-game parlays where you can combine different bets from the same game for even bigger payouts and more action on the hardwood. Bets like live player props, spreads, totals, and more. Add our award-winning customer service and it's nothing but net. Bet Rivers Sportsbook app and basketball. It's a whole new game.
Must be 21 plus. Available in Pennsylvania only. Void where prohibited. Terms and conditions apply. Presented by Rivers Casino Pittsburgh. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Get your new Subaru at A&T Subaru in Sellersville. At A&T, customers get more, like a lifetime powertrain warranty at no cost to you with virtually every vehicle we sell. Shop atsubaru.net.
Hello?
Whether you're at home or on the go, listen to 97.5 The Fanatic on Odyssey on your smartphone, Roku, LG Smart TV, Waze, and more. That's Odyssey, A-U-D-A-C-Y. Check it out now.
More of the Anthony Gargano Show now.
On 97.5 The Fanatic.
All right, 1:30 across the Delaware Valley. Chunis, back to the fighting, Chunis. What's our vibe, Chunis? What's our vibe? I feel a little bit better than I did when I started the show today.
Yeah, I hope I helped you.
You did.
I feel fine, man.
I know you felt you're undeterred, unwavered. And I'm less like looking at the end of what happens in the series. I'm just a little bummed out over the 4-0 lead, because I hate to say this, I never do it. I watch a million games and you always see comebacks, but I was mentally celebrating a win.
Were you looking at World Series ticket prices?
No. I was mentally mentally celebrating the game win, which meant a series win. Like, I got to get, oh, this is my own internal struggle, Judas, right? Like, and it was my own fault because that's a lesson that I long learned. It's a rookie lesson that you never celebrate a win mentally. Like, I didn't say it out loud.
Yeah.
But in my own mind, I was like, I don't think
you were alone because I think I was there too.
Right? I thought Nola up 4-0, I'm good. And I felt like, wow. And this is what I thought. Now, this is, I didn't express it out loud. I didn't tweet it. I didn't post it on Instagram. I just thought it. It was just a thought bubble. And the thought bubble was, they're up 4-0. They're going to win this game. And then they're going to close out the Padres in Philadelphia, back home. And we're going to go to the World Series. That's exactly what I thought. That was my thought bubble.
Yeah, I don't think it was a crazy thought by any means. I mean, you had Nolan, who's been absolutely dominant. And I remember we even said before the game, like, he deserves all the confidence in the world from fans, right? He's been so good, and he was good even to start the game. But it's that dreaded fifth inning that he's dealt with all season long, really, except for those last couple of outings, and unfortunately it got him. Now,
let me ask you a question real quick, because I thought, here's where I thought the real issue came. Forget the fifth inning for one second. I thought the real issue came, those back-to-back home runs. And
yeah, because it brought life back.
Right, and San Diego. I think that was a product of him sitting for that long of an inning.
Maybe. It could be that, yeah. That's probably a part of it. And unfortunately, it played out that way, and it brought life back, especially Bell's home run, right? Because that one was a moonshot.
Yeah.
And the crowd went nuts after that. And, you know, not too long after that, all of a sudden, it's a 5-4 ball game, 6-4 ball game, 7-4 ball game, 8-4, you know, 8-5, they lose. So that sucks, but I know that this offense can still put up runs, the Phillies offense, and they're doing it other ways, whether it's with the power, like you saw with Schwarber and Harper in game one, or with the bleeders, like you saw. They're putting the ball in play, and that's all you can ask for right now in playoff baseball is put the ball in play.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you know what it is, though? I got to get over the mental hurt. This is all mental gymnastics, right? Everything's a mental game, right? And my own mental fandom. I was already in the World Series. Now I got to backtrack and get over the hurdle of going, all right, now we got, you know, Friday night's, like tomorrow night's a monster game, man. Musgrove against the Ranger Danger. Like, that's a huge game because the last thing I want to deal with is being down 2-1.
Yeah, of course not.
Going into a bullpen game.
Yeah, that's kind of terrifying. Now, the beauty is Clevinger hasn't been that good. So if he's the guy that, you know, toes the rubber for the Padres in game four, you still like your chances. Look, they just got to get to Musgrove. They beat him up earlier this year. They put up 6 runs against him. Real Muto had, a 3-run home run. And Stott had a double against him. Like, they had a lot of guys hit Musgrove earlier this season. I know you went through the career numbers earlier in the show, and they didn't look all that good. But the last time they faced them, they rocked them, which is a good sign.
Right.
It was 7 hits, 6 earned. He only went 5 or 6 innings because of it. So you got to feel good if they saw the ball well last time, and it was in Philly, and they'll be back in Philly this time. So I like the sign of that. And as T. Will said earlier today, it's not like they quit after they gave up the lead. Like, they still had chances to come back. They just couldn't put it all together.
Yeah, the one thing about this team is what happens? They come back after you, right? That's the one good sign is that they've shown a lot of fight. And to your point, they fought back. I mean, that gives you a little something, don't you think?
Yeah, it makes me feel good, man. Makes me feel good. And
well, we got to get nuts. Tomorrow, I got to get nuts.
Yeah, tomorrow, you got to get nuts. Because of the way the game played out, Alvarado and Dominguez got a day off, which I think is not that I'm going to cash in a day off for a loss, right? I'm not, like, happy about that. But You'll have 2 days off for those guys because today's a travel day, so right. You'll be able to utilize their arms tomorrow. If Ranger can get you through six, I mean, Matt, if Ranger can give you six innings, right?
Yes.
And you're winning or you're tied, and then you have that back into the bullpen with Alvarado and Dominguez, you feel good. And then it's just a question of who's that other guy that steps up. Is it Brad Hand after yesterday's outing? Does he bounce back? David Robinson, I know he gave up the home run to Machado, but does he bounce back? That was his first time really throwing since the calf injury in a game, so maybe that could help him out a little bit. You got guys in the pen that can give you an inning before you get to Alvarado and Dominguez. It's just really important that Ranger gives you six, and I think he can.
Yeah,
we've talked about this lineup a lot. You're always worried about Soto and Machado, and Josh Bell can hurt you. But after that, you go,
well, the good
all right.
News, here's the one thing. The good news is that Rangers had great success against Soto.
Yeah.
So that's a big deal, having success against Soto.
Hey, it's a huge deal. And so you have to feel good about that. Like I don't know why. I just have a weird feeling that Suarez steps up tomorrow. And I think
you really?
Yeah, that's and good. I go back to what I said at the beginning of the show.
Yeah,
I think a lot
more
of it
is going to be the bats, but I'll definitely take that.
Well, even if it's a quality start, right? The six innings, three earned runs or less, right?
Yeah,
if he goes six innings and you're up 4-3, you're going to take that. You take that in any playoff game, as long as you have the lead, of course. But I think Suarez settles down. I think it was all nerves, that Braves game, and you're on the road too. I think it helps him being at home. He already has a playoff game under his belt. I think he settles in. That I know people keep on bringing up, well, what about the start to close out the season against the Astros? I think they're all hungover and they partied, man. Like if you were a betting man, you took the Astros and you put the house on it, because there was no way that the Phillies were going to win that game after partying all night long. There's no doubt in my mind they partied all night long in Houston. So Suarez had a bad outing. So be it. I think he bounces back tomorrow.
All right. Listen, I'm down with that. I'm going to count. I'm going to hold you to that.
Okay.
I like that.
That's fine.
All right. Because I agree. I like what I think, and I said this earlier to start the show, I want to be 2-2 going into Sunday. I mean, I prefer to be up, 3-1 ready to clinch it.
Yeah, while
right?
We're doing the pregame show, that'd be awesome.
You know, that. I mean, that'd be great. I just want to be 2-2, all right? And then, you know what? I got Wheeler. I think I'm going to win. I go 3-2 back to San Diego, and all I got to do is win one or two games. I mean, I think that's your, other than the obvious, which is you sweep, that's your optimum spot.
Yeah, that would be perfect.
All right.
That'd be perfect. But, hey, you've won already in San Diego, so if it's 2-2 and you win on Sunday, and you just need to win one more in San Diego, which you already did.
That's what I'm talking about. That's it. It's simple. Uncle Frank, you're on 97.5 The Fanatic. Uncle Frank.
Hey, happy. What a fall festive Thursday, boys. It's beautiful out. My God.
I you know what? I just want to get back to the ballpark.
I know you do.
I just want to get back. My mind's going right back to the way. It's funny. I mean, it's the National Championship Series. This is huge, brother.
You know, my man, here's how I look at it. I know you were a little at odds with it earlier. Listen, I'm enjoying the ride. The bar car, I renovated a second car into a bar car. Hey, we're playing with house money.
I agree. Listen, I'm with you on all that stuff. But now that they're here, I want to get to the series, dude. Like, I want to get to the World Series. Like, I feel some stress here, man. I want to go to the World Series. It'd be fantastic.
I'll give you a bro hug tomorrow, and then maybe something a little something. Andrew, a great vault today, by the way.
Thank you.
How about Dick Allen and Will? They had some pipes, man.
Yeah, how about that?
No wonder Will was a stick man. So, we've been away making merry since Sunday, so we've been out of touch. Andrew, the Phillies still in it? They're still in it, right? The Eagles beat the boys. You know, I got to tell you, even though there was an L last night, it's amazing how the sports gods just put our city upon their backs, and they're carrying us, and it's righteous, man. Anyway, it's a good run.
Sports guy, we had the sports guy on.
Was he?
Yeah, he was. He called up, sports guy.
Yeah, did he show up?
Yeah, he's fired up. Yeah, no, he's excited. Listen, he's shining upon us. Yeah, he's there with us.
You know what's cool about our five major sports teams is there's great team unity regarding players supporting their other teams. You know, it's really, I really get enjoyment out of that. You know, and it's cool to see. You see JoJo's at the Eagles game throwing a
football. Yeah, I always talk about that. I agree. Yeah, I love that stuff, Uncle Frank.
Yeah,
I do.
I'm with you, bro. Comes over. But anyway, listen, I'll be in tomorrow. Enjoy the day. And, you know, just don't get out of the Nervine boat. We'll be all right.
All right, buddy. You got it.
All right.
You got him, man. On there. There he is, Uncle Frank. No, no zap for Uncle Frank.
We'll give him, it was his anniversary. I'll give him a good job, Uncle Frank.
Let me ask you a question. But my boy Chris Newsy.
All right.
He goes, I've been waiting all week for this day. Your boy Geek let me down.
Uh-oh.
He told me to start Pickens, and I lost by 2 points. Starting Etienne or Pierce would have given me the dub. I want an apology.
Oh, come on. I mean, you can't be asking for an apology.
So you say no apology. Now, we didn't have enough time to get to
it. The Geek is pretty damn good, but, I mean, he's not perfect.
You know, I kind of think the same thing.
You know, it's like I do all these reads, right, and, you know, for FanDuel, and I give some picks, and sometimes they don't hit. Like, you know, it's part of the game.
Right.
Am I going to sit here and apologize? I could say, hey, look, my bad. I thought they were going to win this game. They didn't. But, you know, you're going to hold me to it every single time you give a pick?
Exactly. Exactly.
The only person that's damn near perfect is Bo Stradamus. Right. And even he had a, you know, he said 2-0. So right. Even Bo Stradamus can miss out every once in a while.
That's right. Bo Adamus, man. Bo Adamus. Sixers Bucks tonight. And a couple things. One, did you know that there's no more Frosty Freeze out?
Yeah, that came out today. You missed out, man. We had some Chick-fil-A dropped off at the station.
I know. It's funny. You are you're a Chick-fil-A man, and I know you're excited over this. The first time an opposing player misses two consecutive free throws in the second half, you get the 5-count nuggets. The second time, you get the 8-count nuggets. And the third time, you're going 12-count nuggets, Judas.
Yeah, that's huge. Did you hear the name they're calling it?
No.
Instead of the Frosty Freeze-Out, it's Brickin' for Chicken. That's a good one. I like Brickin' for Chicken.
Yeah, it's good. I like
it. Yeah, Lil Ant needs like 18 missed free throws.
Dude, I get the, what is the difference?
12 pieces, nothing.
He gets the 30 count.
Yeah, is man.
That's it. Yeah, 30 count.
He's going to need the Nets to come to town so that you can. With Ben Dude, Simmons.
Like I got
to
tell the kid, I go, he go, it's funny. Like, I get done, he gets on football practice or whatever, and he's, you know, he's ready to eat the house, right? And the dude goes, yeah, Daddy, what's for dinner? I go, well, Mommy's making dinner. I want to go to Chick-fil-A. Like, yo, you can't go to Chick-fil-A twice a week, three times a week.
That's protein. It's good for you.
Yeah, Dude, it also it cost me like $40, like $35.
Yeah.
Like, come on, bro. I can't be doing 30-count nuggets every three nights a week. You know what I'm saying? With the shake. That's a lot. That's just him. That's not even Massimo.
Yeah, that's true.
That's right? Anthony alone with the 30-count Chick-fil-A deal. I mean, come on. You can't have that.
No, it's got to be tough for you. Yeah, sorry to hear that.
You know what I'm saying?
I hear you.
That's what all of a sudden. Oh, Mommy's making.
Listen, man,
pasta.
Lyman's got to eat. Lyman's going to eat, man. By the way, speaking of Lyman, I have some audio for you.
All right,
from Jason Kelsey. So okay. Jason and his brother Travis do a podcast together, which
I think it's
cool that they do the podcast together. So they touched on the Tom Brady clip. Did you see him yelling at the O-line the other day?
Yes.
And he's freaking out, yelling at the O-lineman.
Yes.
So
yes.
Travis asked Jason his thoughts on it. So I'll play it for you.
Tom Brady yelling at his O-line. We've seen that before. I guess sometimes you just got to fire the guys up, man.
Did you see the clip?
No, I didn't.
He was yelling at them boys.
We could tone it down a little bit.
Listen, he's Tom Brady. I can't say nothing. Tom yells at me, I'm probably not going to say nothing neither. But playing O-line's hard. If there's one thing I do not like, it is quarterbacks getting into offensive linemen. Like, bro, I am doing the best I can, brother. The f*** up out of my face. I will put you in that trash can over there if you don't shut the f*** up. The last thing I want is a motherfucker that can't get hit, or it's called roughing the passer, to come up to me and tell me how to f***ing wrestle somebody every play. Get the f*** out of here.
Ooh.
I love that, man.
He's the best. Kelsey's the greatest.
I wonder if Jalen watched that. I was like, I'm not saying
it. I will put you in the trash can over there. You're telling me what? That you?
He's the best, man.
Oh, my God. He's right, though. And Brady's guy, he's such a brat. Like, he's always yelling at
Oh, by the way, Brady, it came out today, he apologized for his comments about the deployment. He said on his podcast last week that playing in the NFL this year has felt like being on deployment.
Ooh.
And he got obviously a lot of pushback, like, yo, dude.
Yeah, yo,
dude. You can't. What are you talking about?
Yeah, making $30 million a year.
And
are you out of your mind?
Being on deployment. Come on, man.
I mean, dude, like, that's horrible.
So he
went off the deep end.
Yeah, he did, man. There's a lot going on this year with him.
He's a mess.
And you can tell it's messing them up.
Yeah.
Like, they have a very good defense. They still have weapons. It's just he's, you know, obviously the O-line's a problem. But, man.
He's a problem. All right, Sixers, Nets. By the way, my man Nikki goes, listen, we need the Nets to come into town so everybody can eat.
Yeah.
Because what do you think? Let's do Hackett, Ben, and then everybody feasts on Chick-fil-A when the Nets come in. That's the move, Judas. It's classic. All right, Sixers 4 tonight. I like him tonight, dude. You feeling it?
Home opener and coming off a loss? Yeah. Have to.
I mean, right? You gotta get me tonight. The over-under, Harden points, 22.5. Joe, 26.5. Tyrese, 18.5. I go over Tyrese. What do you think?
Sounds good. I can see that happening.
You like that? All right. We'll put that in your
How about SGP. Tobias, too?
Tobias had a great first half and then didn't get the ball.
I like Tobias. No Chris Middleton.
Yeah, I agree.
I actually
love the Sixers tonight. I think they roll tonight. I think it's a big night for the squad. All right. Stay tuned. Best show ever coming your way. Tyrone, Ricky, Bo, Hunter, and Jen. Everybody, thanks for hanging. As always, we love you. We'll see you a little bit later on for Cousin's Corner. And, of course, tomorrow morning right there at Chickie's.